I'm running up the Moorish highway. If my brother don't go, I can't tarry if my brother don't go. I can't tarry. I'm running up the moving shot. I'm running, running, running. I can't tarry, I'm running, running, running. I can't tarry, I'm running, running, running. I can't tarry, I'm running up the Moorish Highway.
All right, face the east. Five fingers on your left, two on your right. Feet at 90 degrees, 45 on each side. American prayer. Allah the Father of the universe.
Allah the Father of the universe.
Father of love.
Father of love.
Truth.
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 Peace.
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 Freedom.
Freedom. And justice.
And justice. And
justice.
Allah is my protector.
Allah
is my protector.
My guide.
My guide.
My guide.
My
guide.
My salvation.
By night,
my salvation.
By night.
By night.
And by day.
And by
and day.
Whose holy prophet.
Whose holy prophet.
Amen.
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 Rise in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. All praise is due to Allah, Father of the universe. Father of love, true peace, freedom, and justice. The author, the creator. Govern the world, almighty, eternal, and incomprehensible. To the one who is supreme, most wise, and omnipotent. To him alone belongs worship, adoration, thanksgiving, and praises. I like to say, praise Allah, praise Allah, praise Allah, to the divine prophet, the last prophet he did in time, who came in due time to the fallen sons and daughters of the Asiatic nation in North America, teaching them how to learn to love instead of hate. Teaching about their higher self and lower self. Teach those things to make them better men, better women, better husbands, better wives, better children. Teach them to make them be industrial. Our prophet, his brother, man, Prophet Noble Jolly, born and enslaved in North Carolina, January 8, 1886. I'd like to give out to all the prophets of Allah, Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, and Confucius, etc. I'd like to remind the harbinger of the prophet Noble Jolly, as John the Baptist was to Jesus no days in time, so is Marcus about the prophet, he's Muslim days in time, who did spread the nation of victory up the humanity race. You can accomplish what you will. I'd like to remind all the past three gun advisors and moderators of those times of America, Brother C. Creddille-Bey, Brother F. Nelson Bey, and Brother J. Creddille-Bey. I'd like to remind the former Grand Sheikh and moderator of those times of America, Brother R. Love Ear. I'd like to go on to the President Grand Sheikh and moderator of Moorish Science of America, Brother R. Jones Bay, and to the Assistant Brother P. Chase Peer. I'd like to go on to the Grand National Chairman, Sister S. Russell Bell Ball Bay, and to the Assistant Brother B. Bell Bay. I'd like to go on to all the nationals, state, and local officials of the Moorish Science of America. I'd like to go on to our Grand Governor, Assistant of Grand Sheikh, and the Assistant. I'd like to go on to the Grand Governor of the State of New York, Brother C. Burke Bay, and to his assistant, Brother K. Richardson Neal. I'd like to go on to the Grand Sheikh of Temple No. 34, Brother Y. Cyrus Neal, and to his assistant, Brother W. Commander Bay. I'd like to go on to the Grand Sheikh of Americas, Sister E. German Bay. I'd like to go on to all the officials of Temple No. 34. I'd like to go on to all the Sheikh and Sheikhs and all the ministers. I'd like to go on to all the members. I'd like to go on to all the guests, all the sympathizers. I'd like to give out to everyone who's working for the Muslim for humanity. I'd like to give out to our two flags, the American flag for the Republic which stands for the more and the Moorish flag for the divine nation for which to stand with its five highest divine principles known to man. Love, peace, freedom, and justice. I'd like to give out to our charter with the 10 wonders and mysteries of the world. This gives us the right to teach Islam and America without more restriction. I'd like to give out the divine constitution and bylaw, especially in your additional law. The Holy Quran of the Moorish Science of America, the Mandarin pamphlet, all the literature and instructions of the Prophet left for the blessing of fallen humanity. I'd like to go on to everyone who's working for the blessing of fallen humanity. I read the laws of the Moorish Science of America. Salvation, star impression, all seeing eye, our God, hand press, unity. The Moorish Science of America, divine constitution and bylaws, Act 1. The Grand Sheikh and the Chairman of the Moorish Science of America is empowered to make law and enforce laws with the assistance of the prophet and the grand body of the Most High Temple of Allah. The citizen grand sheikh, sister grand sheikh in all affairs, if he lives upon the love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice, and is known before the temple of the Most High Temple of Allah. And two, all meetings of the open prophet according to the circle 7, and love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. Friday is a rest, because on Friday the first man was formed in the flesh, and on Friday the first man departed out of the flesh and ascended unto his Father God, Allah. For that cause, Friday is the holy day for all Muslims all over the world. And three, love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice must be proclaimed and practiced by all members of the Board of Science Temple of America. No matter the support in danger of truth falsehood, his brother or sister, any case in all that may harm his brother or sister, because Allah is love. Act 4. All members must preserve these holy and divine laws and all the laws of government, because by being a more shamir, you're part and partial of the government and must live the life accordingly. Act 5. This organization of the Modern Science Temple of America does not cause any confusion or to overthrow the laws and constitution of this said government with the way we abide. Act 6. With us, all members must protect their nationality, and we're teaching our people their nationality and their divine creed, that they may know that they're part and partial of the said government, and know that they're not Negroes, color folks, black people, or Ethiopians, because these names were given to slaves by slave holders in 1779 and lasted up to 1865 during the time of slavery. But this is a new era of time now, and all men now must proclaim their free national name to be recognized by the government in which they live and the nations of the earth. This is the reason why Allah, great God of the universe, ordained Nabi Muhammad as a prophet to redeem his people from their simple ways. The born Shemarian descendants of the ancient Moabites, whom inhabited the northwestern and southwestern shores of Africa. That's 7. All members must promptly attend their meetings and become a part and partial of all of the acts of the Moorish Science Temple of America. Members must pay their dues and keep in line with our necessities of the Moorish Science Temple of America. Then you are entitled to the name of a husband. You must support your wife and children. Wife, you must obey your husband and take care of your children and look after the duties of your household. Sons and daughters must obey father and mother and be industrious and become part of the living of foreign humanity. All worship must keep their hearts and minds pure with love and vitally clean with water. This divine covenant from the Holy Prophet Nabi Ali, true dance of his father God, Allah. Nabi Ali, founder, worship record prayer. Allah, the Father of the universe, the Father of love, peace, freedom, and justice. Allah is my protector, my guide, my salvation, my night, and my day. To his holy prophet, Ju'ali. Amen. More signs of America, home office 2905 5th Street, Southeast, Washington, D.C., 20032. Let's have the 7 acts of the divine constitution and bylaws of the more signs of America. And I'm going to great meeting is all, Quran question for more America. Page 7. Question in additional laws for the Moorish America by the Prophet Nabi Ali. Act 1. Grand sheikhs and governors and heads of all temple or businesses. He said temple must be approved by the Prophet Nabi Ali. Before acting upon by any member, let it be found as property or any line of life that will cause the support of any group of men. Any former officer who violates these laws is subject to removal from his office under every restriction, etc., by the prophet or the grand sheikh. And 2. All members must attend the adequate meetings and the public meetings promptly. If a member is found standing right in the meeting period, shall be found 50 cents in the first case, and on the second, he be found $1, which will go in the emergency fund. If members work, his monthly dues must be paid, and if he has money in the bank, he must subscribe for as much as he's able to the Moorish Uplifting Fund because it takes finance for uplifting nation. Act 3. It is lawful and divine to do a very good man if he's able to finance for aiding and saving the nation. And if he does not, he's an enemy to the cause of uplifting his own people, and justice must get you. Let it be he or she, according to love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice, As I have the power invested in my hands, I will have to enforce the law in all the Cleveland nation. And for all members, why men in public speech must not use any assertion against the American flag or speak radical against the church or any member of any organized group, because we have to teach love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. Act 5. All members must promptly attend their meetings and send their children to Sunday school. And the teacher must confirm himself with the questionnaire. And let every member exercise his 5 senses who is able to do so, because out from the Sunday school comes the guidance of the nation. Act 6. But us all members must locate their nationality, but we're teaching our people their nationality, their divine creed, that they may know that they are part and partial of this said government, and know that they're not Negroes, color folks, black people, or Ethiopians, because these names were given to slaves by slaveholders in 1779 and lasted them for 1865 during the time of slavery. But this is a new era of time now, and all men now must proclaim a free national name to be recognized by the government which they live and the nations of the earth. This is the reason why Allah, the great God of the universe, ordained Abu Ali, the prophet, to redeem his people from their simple ways. Most remember the census of ancient Moabites who inhabited the northwestern and southwestern shores of Africa. Accept. All members of the company attend their meetings and become part and partial of all of the uplifting acts of the Morrison Center. Members must pay their dues and keep in line with all the necessities of the more science level. Then you're entitled to the name of a husband. You must support your wife and children. Wife, you must obey your husband and take care of your children and look after the duties of your household. Sons and daughter must obey father and mother and be industrious and become part of the living of fallen humanity. All worshipers must keep their hearts and minds pure with love, and your body is clean with water. This divine covenant of your holy prophet, Brother Abu Ali, to the guidance of his father, by Allah. Thus, I read the 7 acts of the question and addition laws to the Moorish American by the prophet, Noble Drew Ali. And now I change the sentence in the Holy Quran and Moorish Science of America, circa 7, divided to be by the Noble Prophet, Drew Ali, by the guidance of his father, God Allah, the great God of the universe, to redeem man from the sinful and fallen stage of humanity back to the highest spirit of life with his father, God Allah. I go to page. I go to page 16. Divine instruction from the Holy Prophet, chapter 10. Jesus spake of the unity of Allah and man to the Hindus. Benares is the sacred city of the Bronze. And in Benares, Jesus taught. Udraka was his host. Udraka made a feast in honor of his guests, and many high-born Hindu priests and scribes were there. And Jesus said to them, with much delight, I speak to you concerning life, the brotherhood of life. The universe of Allah is one, yet is more than one. All things are one. By the sweet breath of Allah, all life is bound with one. So if you touch a fiber of a living thing, you send a trail from the center to the outer bound of life. And when you crush beneath your foot the meanest worm, you shake the throne of Allah and cause the sword of life to tremble in the sheath. The birds sing out a song for men, and men vibrate in unison to help us sing. Astro shepherd's home, to be his shepherd and comb, the spider weep her web, and flower breathe to them, a spirit in a sweet perfume that gives them strength of heart. Now, men and bird and beast and creeping things are deities made flesh. How dare you kill anything? It is cruelty that make the world alive. When men have learned that when they have harmed a living thing, They harm themselves. They surely would not kill, nor cause a thing that Allah is made to suffer pain. A lawyer said, I pray to Jesus, tell, who is this Allah you speak about? Where are his priests? his temple and his shrine. And Jesus says, the law I speak about is everywhere. He cannot become passed with walls or entered by with bounds of any kind. All people worship Allah the one. All people see him, not alike. This universal Allah is wisdom, will, and love. All men see that the triune Allah. One see him as Allah of light, another of Allah of thought, another as Allah of love. A man ideals is his God. So as man unfolds, is God unfolds. Man God today, tomorrow is not God. The nation of the earth see Allah from different points of view. And so, he does not see him the same to everyone. And in the part of Allah, he sees it, and this is to him all of Allah. And every nation sees a part of every nation has a name for Allah. Two Brahmins call him Parabrahm. In Hebrew, and Zeus is a name in Greek. Jehovah is his Hebrew name. But everywhere, he is the causeless cause. The group, this group, in which all things have grown. When men are afraid of Allah and taken for a foe, they dress up other men in fancy garb and call them priests, and charge them to restrain the wrath of Allah by prayer. And when they fail to win his favor by prayer, to buy them off with sacrifice of animals or birds. When men see Allah as one with him, as Father Allah, he needs no middleman no priest to intercede. He goes straight up to him and say, my Father God, Allah. And then he lays his hand in Allah's own hand, and all is one, all is well. And this is Allah. You are each one a priest, just for yourself. Sacrifice of blood, Allah does not want. Just give your life to the service, to the all of life and Allah's food. When Jesus had this said, he stood aside. The people were amazed, who strove among themselves. Some say he's inspired by the Holy Quran. Others say he's insane. Others say he's obsessed. He speaks as devil speaks. But Jesus started out. Among the guests was one, a tiller of the soil, a generous soul, a seeker after truth. He loved the words that Jesus spoke, and Jesus was with him and in his home abode. Just I read the entire chapter, Divine Instruction of the Holy Prophet, chapter 10. Jesus spake of the dignity of Allah and man to them. The fallen sons and daughters of the Ajax nation of North America need to learn to love instead of hate, to know their higher self from lower self. This united the Holy Quran of Mecca, was teaching and instructing all more American, etc. From the Holy Quran and more science of America, know yourself and your Father God, Allah, that you may learn to love instead of hate. Every man needs to worship on his own values, the uniting of ages. I mean, I open the door to the prophet's laws. I'd like to say, be glad to be here with my brothers and sisters. Pray Allah for allowing us the opportunity to come and hear that everlasting gospel, that saving power that comes from Allah to an ancient fathers by his prophet. Because your forefathers were the first to receive the religious creed for the redemption and salvation of mankind. Your forefathers, our forefathers. Not to brag, most of it's true. Truth is the only thing that changes now. Mm-hmm. You know, so we got that same charge to continue to do, raise our brothers out of darkness into the marvelous light. Even our brothers going through whatever they're going through, they're still the God and the God woman of the day. They're just not understanding that within themselves, they got a higher self and they got a lower self. Mm-hmm. They understand within themselves that they can make their adjustments. You know, but sometimes the lower self takes control, you know, of the body that murky eaters of the flesh. Mm-hmm. That's what happened. Take control. And that's where people go in all different directions. But we have to extend to them the truth. We got to tell them the truth about themselves. Whether they understand it now or understand when they understand it later. Right. You know what I'm saying? You just have to plant the problem. Say, plant good seeds and let it germinate. Just plant the seed inside of them. Because, you know, that like I said, sometimes we can move so fast that sometimes I lost souls down to this thing. Because brother said, if I can get you to think, you can save yourself. Mm-hmm. That's very important. If I can get you to think, you can save yourself.
Praise Allah.
Praise Allah for allowing us to have the opportunity to come together in the oneness of His divine love, His divine principle. You know, so allowing us to look at ourselves, to see ourselves. Because each and every one of them is but a seed. The seed that have within is what? Itself? The potencies of Allah. Mm-hmm. It's like the seed of any plant of earth hold deep within itself, the attributes of that special plant. So you know, that's what the Prophet teaches us. The law of man and one. Don't look outside, go within. You know? The best place can be the law is in the heart, the still small voice is speaking. He who hears is still. Then he tells us, you will serve Allah who speak within the heart, serving their kin. Those who are no kin, the stranger at the gate, and the foes seeking to do you harm. Don't worry about your foe. Because the cherubim are serving the rule and station of the sun, and the spirit of the mighty Allah who is so installed, our protectors and our guides, they believe their victory. Prophet, don't worry about how your salvation will come. Just follow his instruction. If you follow instructions, you can't go wrong. When we start deviating, that's what happens. Because we each and every one of us know that when we be disobedient to that still small voice, sometimes we get smacked. And we have to understand, okay, yeah, we gotta make sure that we gotta make those adjustments. We gotta make those adjustments within ourselves because that's the lesson that we have to learn. Because without a foe, soldier never knows the strength. Thought must be developed by exercise of strength. So praise Allah for the divine instruction. Praise Allah for this lesson.
Praise Allah.
Chapter 10. Brotherhood of Life. What's that? Yeah. Praise Allah for the divine instruction. Chapter 10 talk about the unity. He didn't speak about the law and man for the Hindus. Because remember, Hindus, you know, they have a lot of different ways of practice. They have castles. The highest is the lowest. The lowest was not permitted to even hear or listen to the holy teachings. You know, but that's why I say what the prophet brought. Because everything we need to save the nation, take it and save ourselves. But important. Take it and save yourself. But this is a life. Like learning, like experience, because it's talking about studying itself. When you study yourself, then you can use the tool and the workshop of the mind with things that are made of thought, and when you build a character, you can use the acts. Because when there's ungainly parts within yourself, each and every one of us had those parts that we had to work on. But the Bible said, if you act in what to study, I will say yourself. If you went up studying them, then when acting what to study them, I will reply to yourself. But you gotta study, continue to study yourself. If you want to see the omnipotence of Allah within each and every one of us. When I look at the face of man or woman, I look at the spirit of Allah who speak within. Then we talk about faith. He said, faith is the surety of the omnipotence of Allah and man, the certainty that man will reach what? The end of life. But he has to follow the instructions. Jesus said, what I've done, I'll make me do, what I am, all men shall do. You can't show the possibility of what you can do, what's within you. And you tell the richest gems are bound within each and every one of us. We got to go within. We got to go within our own God, put our own weeds. So I'm saying, chapter on those things that choke the flower, the choicest flower. That's what even within us. That's why I said, bursting out the song for men, and men vibrate in unison to help us sing.
That's right.
See? Because we are connected. Every living thing is bound by cord to every other living thing. Your brothers and sisters are hurting, you should be a son.
Mm.
So that's why Jesus' heart was stirred with pity and love for the toilers. When he saw him, he said, you know, the other mistake that they, the only thing that they know is they can work and die and wait till they make the Buddha sweet of the day.
Mm.
Because that's what he was teaching them. But Jesus told him, your thoughts are wrong. The heaven is no far away. It's not a place to reach the mouth. It's not a country. It is a state of mind. and create his own heaven, his own hell. We create. So we got to be very careful, because the man Harlan thought was it be another man, he done wrong to Allah. So we got to be careful. Got to be able to be humble ourselves, be submissive. Praise Allah for these divine instructions. Pray Allah that the sentence of the divine prophet, the last prophet of the day of time.
Praise Allah.
At this time, I'd like to call the first speaker. Even before I bring him forth, please give me your divine attention. I'd like to call Brother J. Coleman Neal after a song.
Waiting in the water, Muslim. Wait in the water, Muslim. Wait, oh, wait in the water, Muslim. Giovanni got in trouble, the water. Oh, who's that yonder all dressed in green? Giovanni got in trouble, the water. It must be the Muslim that Giovanni redeemed. Giovanni got in trouble, the water. Singing, wait in the water, Muslim. Wait in the water, Muslim. Wait, oh, wait in the water, Muslim. Giovanni done in trouble, the water. Oh, who's that yonder all dressed in red? Giovanni done in trouble, the water. It must be the Muslim that Giovanni led. Giovanni done in trouble, the water. Singing, wait in the water, Muslim. Wait in the water, Muslim. Wait, oh, wait in the water, Muslim. Giovanni done in trouble, the water. Oh, who's that yonder all dressed in white? Giovanni done in trouble, the water. It looks like the host of the Moabites. Giovanni done trouble, the water. Singing, wait, oh, wait in the water, Muslim. Wait in the water, Muslim. Wait, oh, wait in the water, Muslim. Giovanni done trouble, the water.
Happy Holy Day.
Happy Holy Day.
First, I want to rise and give praise to Allah, the Father of the Universe, the Father of Earth, peace, freedom, and justice. I give honors to the last prophet in these days and time, Prophet Nabi to Ali, the founder of the Mauritanian Temple of America, 1913 AD. I give honors to Brother Marcus Mosiah Garvey, who came with one God, one name, and one destiny. I give honors to the Moore Scientific America and everybody a part of the national and divine movement. I give honors to all guests. I give honors to everything, the Grand Chief and the Chairman of that honesty. I give honors to man, because the man, honest man, the honest Father God, Allah. Peace.
Peace. Brother Comedale.
Islam.
Islam, beloved, do you have a headpiece or something plugged into your microphone? We can hear you, but it's just a little low. I want to make sure you come through clear.
Hold on one second.
Islam,
you know, sometimes in life, you know, us as men, you know, as physical men, you know, we in the more scientific America, we understand that death is no enemy to man, it's a friend, you know, so we know that we're not the body or the soul, but we're spirits, so sometimes we physically get, you know, we get sad at times because, you know man is not the body or soul, but he's a spirit, so sometimes we miss the physical part of man. When he leaves, when his work is done. You know, but I'm gonna turn your attention to the Holy Quran of the Moore Science Temple of America, divinely prepared by the noble prophet Drew Ali, by the guidance of his father, God Allah, the great God of the universe, to redeem man from the separate way, fallen state of humanity back to how he's playing life with his father, God Allah. I'm just gonna read, because I only have a little bit of time, so I'm just gonna read a instruction out the Quran. Holy Divine Instructions from the Prophet, chapter 4, the ministry of death, death and burial of Elizabeth Medina's lesson, the ministry of death. Instruction 4, no language. Actually, I'm gonna go to 3. Death is no enemy to man. It is a friend who, when the works of life is done, just cuts the cord that binds the human boat to earth, that it may sail on smooth seas. There's a lot of work we have to do in this life. And there's a lot of work we got to do in the spirit life. So, you know, we just got this. Pardon me more. I'm at work right now. I'm at work. Pardon me. I'm going to leave you on a piece.
Peace.
Peace.
You can look to the east and you can look to the west. Throughout it untroubled water. Everywhere you look, the whole world's in a mess. Throughout it untroubled water. Sing it. Waiting the water, Mazda. Waiting the water, Mazda. Wait, oh, waiting the water, Mazda. Throughout it untroubled water. Jewel in trouble, the water. Jewel in trouble, the water.
Islam?
Islam.
I'd like to thank Brother J. Coleman Neal.
Praise Allah.
For reading from the Divine Circle, from the Divine Circle of the Holy Prophet, chapter 4, death and burial of Elizabeth, the female lesson, the ministry of death, instruction 3. Death is no enemy of man, is a friend who, when the works of life is done, is cut the cord that binds human both the earth and keep the tail and the field. So praise Allah, our brother Creddille-Bey, praise Allah. Mm-hmm. Beautiful brother, you know, make the transition. But you know, like I say, the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
There's no death to the spirit. As long as the law lives, man cannot die. You know what I'm saying? The body go back the way it goes, but the soul go in the other plane and then go back to the spirit. So praise Allah. That man was a DJ and he made many people's hearts.
That's right.
Happy. You know what I'm saying? I watch him all the time. He be in it. He be in another zone.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
You know, nice. Touching the hearts, the mind, just keep the rhythm, because you know rhythm are things that allow people to just tenderate energy within themselves and feel good, you know, and it's also gonna make them feel sad sometimes too. Some songs, but you know, but that more will keep the energy flowing.
Mm-hmm.
Praise Allah for mm-hmm. him. I praise Allah that he continued to do the work. He was blessed with a gift. On this plane, I think may manifest, and he did what he's supposed to do. This thing may manifest. And just when his time was up, he just cut the cord that binds human boat to earth.
Mm-hmm.
They sail on smoother seas.
Mm-hmm.
Went to, you know, it's on the other plane. And like I said, there's a plane that was seen it, plane unseen, but it go run simultaneously together. So praise Allah.
Praise Allah.
I just kind of like to call the next speaker, even before I bring it forth, please leave me out there by a second. Let's thank Brother King. Turn the page after the song.
We're marching. We're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city of love. Now if you want to know where we're bound, that beautiful city of love, into the holy city, Moabites, define that beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city of love. It's where the physical part of man was first formed. That beautiful city of love. At the east gate, the cherubim with the flaming sword. That beautiful city of love. Now we're marching, we're marching,
They marching into Mecca, that beautiful city on love. Now we're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city on love.
If you don't mind,
Ali, please take my hand. That beautiful city of love.
Now the ancient
name is Eden down in Canaan land. That beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca. That beautiful city of love. Now we're marching. We're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city of love.
Islam. I rise, giving praises to the great God of the universe, who we call Allah. I give high esteem honors to the prophet Noble Drew Ali, who gave us everything it takes to save a nation and said, take it and save yourself. I give honor to the forerunner of the prophet, Brother Marcus Mosiah Garvey, who said, up, up, you mighty nation, and accomplish what you will. Mm-hmm. I give honors to the past Supreme Grand Sheik and moderator, Brother C. Creddille-Bey. I give honors to the past Grand Sheik of the Moore Science Temple, Brother Emiliel. I give honor to the present Grand Sheik of the Moore Science Temple of America, Brother R. Jones Bay, and his official staff. I give honors to Temple 34 and its Grand Sheik, Brother Y. Cyrus L. and his official staff. I give honors to the Grand Governor of the State of New York, Brother C. Herb Bate, and his official staff. I give honor to the American flag, the flag of my birth, for which it stands. I give honor to the Moorish flag, the flag of my descent, for which it stands. I give honor to the Moors and a happy holy day. That's on the line listening.
Islam.
I give honors to the guest that's on the line listening this holy day. I give honor to Moors here, there, and everywhere.
Praise
giving praise to the great God Allah on this holy day.
Islam.
I would like to take a moment, if you will, to read a prayer that the Grand Sheik posted in our group chat, if I may.
Islam.
It says, O Allah, we come to you in prayer asking that you receive our brother in your hands as he has finished another round in his cycle of life. We pray that you continue your guidance and protection as he prepares for the next stages. Your obedient son, who has heard the call of our prophet and took heed to his instructions, we testify that Brother Gary Creddille-Bey was a true and faithful Moorish American and one of the first in his immediate family. He set a clear example for them to follow, a seeker after truth and a submitter to your will. We pray that you are pleased with his efforts. And we pray in Allah's name. Amen.
Amen. Islam.
Islam.
Praise Allah. Thank you.
No question. You're welcome. I had a real thought of something prepared when the Grand Sheik, you know, called on me to speak. But yet again, you know, the energy is just moved me somewhere else, because because of the ministry of death, right? And had me remembering, you know, my grandmothers and how they introduced me to religion. You know, my grandmother Ann Turner, Hildred Ann Turner, she was the first to introduce me to a religious life, which was Jehovah's Witness.
Right.
And we used to read the Bible at least 4 to 5 times a week.
Mm.
And as a youth, I had to read the Bible to myself during the daytime when I was home. And I used to have so many questions, you know, but mostly I was fascinated with the stories in the Bible. I used to see them as, you know, as lessons and look deep and think deeply about them. And I didn't even understand why.
Hmm.
Right. So when we would go to the Kingdom Hall, these questions would pop up in certain images I would see. And one of them was the image of Jesus. And I had just read that in Revelations, he had a skin tone the color of bronze.
Mm-hmm.
And the image that I seen, it perplexed me as a kid. And I was only, 5 or 6 years old. So it confused me at that time. And when I asked one of the elders, he instructed me to ask my grandmother. And I looked at him. I remember the face. I mean, I was perplexed. Like, huh? Like, you the elder. Like, so I was like, wow. So I went to my grandmother and she told me something I didn't understand at that time until I got much older. She said, oh, baby, he's every color.
Hmm.
So you telling a 5-year-old, 6-year-old child that Jesus is every color, that's reading it and it says he's a specific complexion.
Right.
So at that time, I didn't understand, right? But as I got older, this is when wisdom comes along and I honor the wisdom that she had at that time to protect me for what I might say, right? Knowing that I'm reading and I'm comprehending what I'm reading. So, you know, now I understand she used very good discretion and wisdom, and I honor her and her life and the character she installed in me and the character that I seen in her. Because the images of my grandmothers, Ann Turner and Queen Esther Hodges, was that of chastened, faithful, humble, spiritually moved women, right? So the happiness that I had when I was in my youth, you know, I long for as I get older, because it's very hard to find that structure today in society, that family structure, right? You know, because when I was a youth, we sat around the table and ate. Uncles, mother, grandmother. That was a family structure, you know, very positive, very happy.
Mm-hmm.
So, you're just reflecting on the happiness of life, because sometimes, like the brother said, you know, these murky ethers could affect the lower self. And it can make you emotional to these ethers if you don't know how to control your emotions and the ethers that move so and so, right? That may seem murky, it may seem gloomy, right? But then I take the instructions of Allah and the Holy Prophet and I contemplate that frame. And then I contemplate the creation of Allah. Right? How the bird sings, right? So we can hear how the ants construct their home. And I marvel at the creation and their unity. And then there's a still small voice, not saying it's a love's voice, but it just says, look at our human condition. Right? Look at our human condition. It's so awry and it can make one gloomy, right? To think about the things that can affect our emotion, especially when a loved one moves into the spirit or the soul plane, right? Because then we can't physically say hello, speak to them. But you know what?
Yeah.
I think Allah showed me that that ain't true.
Mm.
Because there's many nights, right? I've slept, or I think I'm asleep and dreaming, that both of my grandmothers came and ministered to me.
Wow.
Right? And I lie to you not, Morris. It was like, let me see, how can I explain this? It was like reality.
When
you can feel the power of the voice speaking to you. You can hear the love speaking to you that you already knew, that never left. Right?
Right.
So we have to take heed of these things because we are endowed with truth. Because like the brother said, death is no enemy to man.
Mm-hmm.
So we take death as an enemy because we know not but being told.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Wow. And that's the emotional part. But when we go to truth, man is not the body nor the soul. He is spirit and one with the law. We can understand, so thus we comprehend. Right?
Allah.
And then when we manifest our own abilities, we can communicate with that soul realm or that spirit realm. Because like the brother Jesus, we can transmute at will.
Praise Allah.
Right? We have to know this, Moors. We have to practice this. We have all the attributes, all the potencies within us to communicate on different ether planes.
Praise Allah.
Mind can speak to mind without saying a word. Mind could move matter without moving a finger. If you don't believe it, you don't understand or comprehend truth. And right. I implore you to test your abilities. Right? Test your abilities. And like me, sometimes don't get caught up in the murky ethers of this world, right? Because it may look gloomy, it may look awry, but it says in chapter six of the Holy Quran of the Moor Science Temple, I believe, right?
Mm-hmm.
Chapter 26, the unity of the instructions of unity.
Holy instructions of unity, that's 26.
Key 10. Nevertheless, the attainment of virtue he accounteth as the highest learning. And the science of happiness is the study of his life. So when I'm feeling emotional about the awryness of the world, I reflect on that study of happiness, things that aren't concerned with the gloom of the world, and practice unity and life.
Praise Allah. Right?
And I implore you, Moors, that are feeling the loss of anyone at any time, just know you can speak to them if you will.
Praise Allah.
Right? Notice the word will. Because the law says, Noble Drew Ali says, thought is the cause of it all.
Praise Allah.
And with that, I leave you Moors in peace.
Peace. If you don't
peace, have Islam, peace.
You'll be ready. That beautiful city of
Abla.
Take it into Mecca, cause the age is protected.
That beautiful city of love.
We're marching.
That beautiful city of love. We're marching. That beautiful city of love.
I've never been to heaven, but I've been told that beautiful city of love, that the streets are made of pearls and the gates are gold. That beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca, that beautiful city of love. Now the prophet did exactly just what he said, that beautiful city of love. He healed all the sick and he raised the dead. That beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca. That beautiful city of love. Now we're marching into Mecca. That beautiful city of love.
Islam. I'd like to thank Brother K. Creddille-Bey.
Praise Allah.
For being from the divine instruction of the Holy Prophet, and also for the put out.
Islam.
And also for the energy that he put out.
Praise Allah.
And the thought that he put out concerning, you know, the world of the seen and the world of the unseen. Mm-hmm. You know, they just step behind the veil. The other plane, that's all it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but with the eyes of soul, all creatures see the speech of planes.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm saying, so you got to use your spirit, your third eye, go through those planes. You know, so praise Allah for his instruction, and praise Allah for sharing the information about his grandmother. And it's very important because, like I said, you know, a lot of us may experience something like that in our lives. That is not strange. You know, because they're still amongst us. Our ancestors is always with us. You know? Pray the Lord, thank you for reading us for his coming. I just kind of like. I just kind of like to call the next speaker. He's been cooperating for peace. Came here on the divine intention. I'd like to call up Brother Elsa around the Bay, she divine minister, after the song.
Oh, I can't see Allah, but I feel him in my bones. Oh, I feel him in my bones. Oh, I feel him in my bones. Oh, I can't see Allah, but I feel him in my bones. Feels like fire stirred up. Fire stirred up. Fire stirred up. Oh, in my bones. In my home, where's the nearest place to meet them? We meet them all in our hearts. Oh, we meet them all in our hearts. Oh, we meet them all in our hearts. Where's the nearest place to meet them? We meet them all in our hearts. It's like fire stirred up. Fire stirred up. Fire stirred up, all in my bones, in my bones. Who is Noble Drew Ali? He's a prophet of Allah. He's a prophet of Allah. He's a prophet of Allah. Who
with noble true Ali. He's a prophet of Allah. Feels like fire stirred up. Fire stirred up. Fire stirred up. Oh, in my bones, in my bones.
Islam.
Islam.
Islam. First I rise and I give all praise to the great God Allah. I give honors to his holy and divine prophet, Noble Jew Ali. I give honors to our past supreme grand advisors and moderators of the Moore Science Temple of America, Brother C. Kirkman Bey, Brother F. Nelson Bey, and Brother J. Blakely Bey. I give honors to our former Grand Sheikh, Brother R. LaVille, and our present Grand Sheikh, Brother R. Jones Bey, and his assistant, Brother B. Chase Ill. I give honors to the chairman of the Moore Science Temple of America, Sister S. Dunbar Bey, and her assistant, Brother V. Bell Bey. I give honors to the Grand Governor of the State of New York, Brother C. Herb Bey, and his assistant, Brother K. Richardson Ill. I give honors to our Grand Sheikh here at Temple No. 34, Brother Y. Cyrus Ill, his assistant, Brother W. Clendenin Bey. I give honors to our treasurer, Brother T. Barry Bey, his assistant, Sister C. Silzill, Sister B. Reeves Bay. I give honors to our secretary, Sister L. Barry Bay. I give honors to all of our national, state, local officers, sheiks, members, foreign sympathizers. And I give honors to man, because when man honors man, he honors his father, God Allah. Islam. So I just wanted to talk about Brother G. Creddille-Bey. Brother G. Creddille-Bey, my interaction with the brother, he was a very strong brother, very humble, very charismatic.
Wow.
The brother had a strong spirit. You know, you could tell that he's been through a lot of things in life, a lot of ups and a lot of downs. I think the brother was very humble too. He had a very humbleness to him as well. He had no problem at all saying if he was wrong or if someone was right or anything that will help him better himself or get himself closer to where he wanted to go as far as his own development in life.
Praise Allah.
You know, I just remember the brother, I could see his face, you know, constantly asking me to call him. He's call me.
Right. That's right.
And, you know, And I just, it makes me think about the word call. And, you know, when you hear the prophet's call, the brother heard the prophet's call, you know, and now Allah called them home. And we know that death is no enemy of man, right? It is a friend who, when the work of life is done, just cuts the cord that binds the human boat to earth, that he may sail on smoother seas. And our brothers, my brother is on smoother seas. You know, a man will find himself where he could solve his problems best. With that, I'm going to just take a reading from the Holy Quran of the Moore Science Temple of America. I'm going to read chapter 9 on page 14. Jesus attends a feast in Bihar, and here he taught human equality. Instruction 1. The fame of Jesus as a teacher spread through all the land, and people came from near and far to hear his words of truth. At Bihar, on the sacred river of the Brahms, he taught for many days. And Ak, a wealthy man of Bihar, made a feast in honor of his guest, and he invited everyone to come. And many came, among them thieves, extortioners, and courtesans. And Jesus sat with them and taught. But they who followed him were much aggrieved because he sat with thieves and courtesans. and they upbraided him. They said, Rabbani, master of the wise, this day will be an evil day for you. The news will spread that you consort with courtesans, and men will shun you as they shun an ass. And Jesus answered them and said, a master never screens himself for the sake of reputation or of fame. These are but worthless babbles of the day. They arise and sink like empty bottles on a stream. They are illusions and will pass away. They are the indices to what the thoughtless think. They are noise that people make, and shallow men judge merit by the noise. Allah and all master men judge men by what they are and not what they seem to be, not by their reputation and their fame. All right, we know that, as our chairman, Brother C. Ferguson, has just stated, that man and Allah are one. All right? So we all have Allah within us all. Right? Brother G. Creddille-Bey, may Allah bless him. Allah was in that brother too. We don't see the physical. We know death is no enemy of man, right? And while Allah lives, man cannot die, right? The prophet teaches us that. The prophet teaches us that the duty of the more science type of America is to teach men how to be themselves, right? But man is himself his highest self. And we know that the highest self is Allah and man, right? So Allah is in him, is in all of us, right? The prophet is reported that the prophet also stated that if you see the prophet in a dream, you know, believe that that is your prophet. Because no spirit can incarnate into the image of the prophet in your dream. And the same way we can do that is the same way we can speak to Brother G. Creddille-Bey as well.
You know,
the prophet gives us the tools. We have silent meditation. You know, the nearest place to meet Allah is in the heart, and man and Allah are one. So you could have that connection, and you could speak to your brother. I'm going to continue this on instruction 11. It says, these courtesans and thieves are children of my father, Allah. Their souls are just as precious in his sight as yours or of the Brahmic priests. And they are working out the same life sums that you have saw, you men who look at them with scorn. And some of them have solved much harder than you have saw, you men who look at them with scorn. Yes, they are sinners and confess their guilt, while you are guilty, but are shrewd enough to have a polished coat to cover up your guilt. Suppose you men who scorn the courtesan, these drunkards and these thieves, who know that you are pure in heart and life, that you are better far than they, stand forth that man may know just who you are. The sin lies in the wish and the desire, not in the act. You covet other people's wealth. You look at charming forms, and deep within your heart, you lust for them. Deceit you practice every day and wish for gold, for honor, and for fame, just for your selfish selves. The man who covets is a thief, and she who lusts is a courtesan. You who are none of these, speak out. Nobody spoke. The accusers held their peace. And Jesus said, the proof this day is all against those who have accused. The pure in heart do not accuse. The vile in heart who want to cover up their guilt with holy smoke of piety are ever loathing drunkards, thieves, and courtesans. This loathing, this scorn is mockery. For if the tinsel coat of reputation could be torn away, the loud professor would be found to revel in his lust, deceit, and many forms of secret sin. The man who spends his time in pulling other people's weeds can have no time in pulling his own, and all the choices, flowers of life will be choked and die, and nothing will remain but darnel thistles and burrs. And Jesus spoke a parable. He said, behold, a farmer had great fields of ripened grain, of ripened grain. And when he looked, he saw that blades of many stalks of wheat were bent and broken down. And when he sent his reapers forth, he said, "We will not save the stalks of wheat that have the broken blades. Go forth and cut and burn the stalks with broken blades." And after many days, he went to measure up his grain, but not a kernel could be found. And then he called the harvesters and said to them, "Where is my grain?" They answered him and said, "We did according to your word. We gathered up and burned the stalks with broken blades, and not a stalk was left to carry to the barn." And Jesus said, "If Allah serves only those who have unbroken blades, if Allah saves only those who have unbroken blades, who have been perfected in his sight, who will he save?" And the accusers hung their heads in shame, and Jesus went his way. I just want to say praise Allah, praise Allah, praise Allah. Highest honors to our holy and divine prophet for establishing the Moorish Science Temple of America. For if it was not for this corporation, you know, I wouldn't have had the blessing to have met this brother, as well as you all. I just want to say that we should let the brother's life be inspiration unto us, and also a reminder to us that we don't take each other for granted. We give our flowers to the living. You know, we never know when it's our last time here in this physical flesh. So we need to just be more appreciative of life. If you have any problems with anyone, they're not as important as much as the delicacy of life. You know, you could disagree with anyone. You could disagree, you know, family, friends, members, anyone, leader of the organization. But we put love up front. Our first principle is love. Second principle is truth. So we speak the truth. We speak the truth out of love, you know, and we could disagree with one another, but we have to use those bonds of affections that unite us, and just continue to unite one another, and just keep unity up front. And may Allah bless us all. I wish you all a happy holy day. And with that, I say peace.
Amen. Everybody say amen. Everybody say amen. Amen. Talking about the prophet. Amen. Tell him all the stories.
Amen.
Talking about the prophet. Amen. Amen. Honor to the Father, honor to the Mother, honor to the children, amen, amen, honor to the temple, honor to the grandchief, honor to the sister, amen, amen. Honor to the Father, honor to Allah, honor to the Father, amen, 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 praise Allah, amen, praise Allah, amen, amen, amen. Islam?
Islam.
I like that, brother. Elsewhere on the debate, Chief Divine Minister.
Praise Allah.
We're reading for the divine instruction of the Holy Prophet, chapter 9. She attended your feast in the heart and he taught human equality. It's a beautiful
chapter.
Like I said, we got to deal with everybody equally, you know, separate. the people, you know, the quarter cents, the feed, the extortioners, drug addicts, everybody in the street. We got to deal with that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they just caught up in a cycle of life. A cycle of life. So we got to stand our hands to help them because we end up lifting business.
That's right.
We're supposed to uplift all of humanity. That's our job. I've been probably going to this in most America, but I'm teaching them to be them. So
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, that's very important. We need to uplift them business. I thank the Chief Divine Minister for his comments and sharing what he shared. On behalf of our brother, Chief Creddille-Bey, praise Allah.
Praise Allah.
At this time, I'd like to call the next speaker, even before I bring her forward. Please give her any divine attention. I'd like to call Sister C.C. O'Neill, Chief Divine Minister, after the song.
Watch ye therefore, ye know not the hour when Allah shall come and call the weak. If you labor, strive for the right, and he shall wear a golden crown. I shall wear a bright and shining crown. Muslims when the trumpet sound. I shall wear a bright and shining crown, and I shall wear a golden crown. Not like the foolish virgin there, when Allah shall come and call for thee. Just keep your lamp all full and burning bright, and he shall wear a golden crown. I shall wear a bright and shining crown. Muslims, when the trumpet sound, I shall wear a bright and shining crown, and I shall wear a golden crown. Lead me to Wali, lead me all the way, closer and closer, lead me every day. Lead me to Wali, let's not go astray, and I shall wear a golden crown. I shall wear a bright and shining crown. Muslim, when the trumpet sounds, I shall wear a bright and shining crown, and I shall wear a golden crown.
Islam? Are you able to hear me clearly, Morris?
Yes, yes, we can. She gets loud and clear.
Yes, praise, I hear you clearly.
Allah. Gratitude. Praise Allah. Praise Allah. Praise Allah. First, I rise and give praises to the great God, the one God, universal God, Allah.
Allah.
I give honor to our prophet, a divine prophet. I give honors to all the divine prophets of Allah. I give honors to our brother Marcus Messiah Garvey, who just had a birthday the other day. You know, brother O. Rosado Bay sometimes sends things out in a text and give a nice little reminder, and that was one of them. I give honors to our brother Forerunner, brother Marcus Messiah Garvey. I give honors to all the forerunners of all the divine prophets, because we know purity must first pave the way for love. I give honors to the past Supreme Grand Advisors and moderators of this Morris Science Temple of America, Brother C. Kirkman Bay, Brother F. Nelson Bay, Brother J. Blakely Bay. I give honors to the past Grand Sheikh of the Morris Science Temple of America, Brother R. Love Ill and his staff. I give honors to our present Grand Sheikh and moderator of the Morris Science Temple of America, Brother R. Jones Bay, and his staff and all those that assist him. I give honors to all of the national, state, and local officials. I give honors to our Grand Governor here in the state of New York, Brother C. Creddille-Bey, and his assistant, Brother K. Richardson Hill. Thought about it, I also give honors to his grand chief, right? Brother D. Clark Hill, you know, he starts to realize how much and how many roles everyone plays in each other's growth development. As soon as you think you're teaching a lesson, you're learning one, as if you're open for it. Mm. Always an exchange. I also want to give honors to our grand chief here at Temple Number 34, Brother Y. Cyrus Hill. I also want to extend those honors to his family, right? They support that brother in the day-to-day toil.
Praise Allah. Islam.
I give honors to our assistant grand chief, Brother W. Creddille-Bey, and his family, because they also support him in his day-to-day toil. I give honors to our brother chairman, also the grand governor of the state of Connecticut, Brother C. Ferguson Hill, and his family, his loved one. They also give him the support that he needs to toil. I give honors to his assistant, Sister L. Creddille-Bey, and her family. They give her the strength that she needs to toil on the hill. I give honors to our brother Mufti, who's also our treasurer, Brother T. Creddille-Bey, and his family, because they give him the strength to toil. I give honors to also Sister B. Creddille-Bey and her family, the Creddille-Beys, and others. We're her family too, right? So the honors extends to all of you.
Praise Allah. It's love.
As we give each other the strength we need to toil. I want to give special honors to our brother Creddille-Bey, who Arb of Flesh was needed no more. Oh, that means, you know, from what I've read within our Holy Quran, that means he passed his test first. Right. So I'm looking like, oh man, the bull beat us to it, you know? And I try not to allow me to go down, right, into that state of melancholy, bringing up the feelings and a part of it that's going to miss, because then it's a part of it in us that arises with a selfishness.
That's right.
And no, I'm like, they're solving problems here as well as there. That's like trying to hold somebody back that deserves to pass to the next grade just because you want to see them in your chair. You know, let's let our brother's noble life, as the speakers before us said, that brother was a strong brother, mm-hmm. You know, because it takes strength to come out of parts of life. Why do I say that, right? Looking through the Facebook page, you can see all different kinds of things, but you can see the different people that were passing credit, love, and respect from different walks of life. That speaks of great growth.
Yeah.
That speaks to me of a Jesus demonstration where he can sit and exchange with anyone and not feel offended, not be nervous. You know, not be concerned with what others might think and feel, but truly they all share the same message. Thanks for always trying to share some wisdom between the good vibrations and the music and sharing, you know, information. But our brother was also legal minded.
That's right, so
he was structured in different aspects of law. The prophet's law was one of the ones that he held really strong to.
I'm
so grateful to have come in contact with such a strong brother. Why? Because the prophet's calling on strong men and women. And when you see strength, you recognize strength, you realize that the prophet made a call. And I keep saying I, right? Because I don't want to speak for others, not because I just want to make it about me. But as I hear the tones and I hear the communication of all the Moors, all of you are deserved honors. All of you are learning. All of you have grown. All of you have shared a jewel that we can each walk away with tonight about transmuting, about no longer seeing our physical loved one. But we all spoke to the same thing, the consistency of feeling that vibration.
Praise Allah.
It brought me to when Jesus appeared, truly materialized.
That's right.
to the eastern stages in the palace of Prince Ravana in India, to the Magian priests in Persia, and then these wise men speak in praise of the personality of the Nazarene, speaking of Jesus. So this was all after he had been crucified.
Islam. That's right.
It appeared. Now it goes, that's chapter 19. I'm going to be reading from the Divine Instructions on the Holy Prophet found on page 31. I'm sorry, I'm going to start at instruction 15. The gospel of the resurrection of the dead is not confined to Jew and Greek. It is the heritage of every man of every time and clime. And I am here a demonstrator of the power of man. Then he arose and pressed the hand of every man and of the royal host and said, I'm going to go to instruction 19. I know they're all important. I go my way, but you shall go to all the world and teach the gospel of the omnipotence of man.
That's right.
The power of truth.
Right.
The resurrection of the dead. He who believes this gospel of the Son of Man shall never die.
Praise Allah.
The dead shall live again. Then Jesus disappeared, but he had sown the seed. The words of life were spoken in Orissa, and all of India heard. This was a message that was originally passed down in India.
Praise Allah. Right.
It was made clear in instruction 29, to you I come, the first of all the race to be transmuted to the image of Allah. He came and dropped off the jewels with them first, but it didn't stand in just their hands. Mm-hmm. We've got jewels of words spoken through Jesus.
Teach this.
Thanks to our holy prophet, Jesus come again, bringing the messages of the first transmutation, I'm going to call it, of man and its experiences within the world, right? Because now he's telling you that was the start of something major, because it's going to be that way for us all.
Right.
That's the time to prepare. That's the time to stand firm and prepare. And it says to teach. Why? Because the more that you teach, express, the more you remind yourself. Because it takes repetition as the best teacher. Wow, we got to tarry on this plane many lifetimes.
Woo!
Now, when I look at our brother Creddille-Bey and his example that he left, whether or not you in this Moorish Science Temple of America at this moment got a chance to meet the brother, you are going to forever have some remnants of that brother's vibration from those that he has touched.
Praise Allah.
In chapter 10 that was just read, it spoke to an instruction 5, I believe. I'm flipping through the Holy Quran, so, you know, just one quick second. Instruction 5. On page 16, the divine instruction from the Holy Prophet, Jesus spake on the unity of Allah and man to the Hindus, right? But by the sweet breath of Allah, all life is bound in one.
Right.
So if you touch a fiber of a living thing, you send a thrill from the center to the outer bounds of life. So, if you feel something, because this was the fiber of a living thing that's been touched. Anything that infiltrates the body is still a living thing. And that bacteria and its origin will also have something to reap for that.
Right.
Just know. Just know the cause of death are always for the best. Which is why we have to sympathize with our brothers and sisters who might call themselves Black.
Because black, according to science, means death, but the cause of death is always for the best. Now understand, classification of ourselves is one thing, but to understand the connection, to let the bonds of affection therefore unite thee with thy brothers, that peace and happiness may dwell in thy father's house. Mm-hmm. It takes a certain state of mind. And I just want to also just extend encouragement to any of you who might be feeling, you know, as our brother Barry Bay extends encouragement, I thought that was a great thought. You know, we'll extend condolences because we understand, but he raised it up and said he's going to extend encouragement, you know, to give you that energy to keep going. I hope that this is encouraging you to look more into that process, to make sure that you're one of those that can conquer when the time comes, to make sure that you're not caught unprepared. I hope that gives you a reminder. And you know, and Grand Sheik, honest to you for allowing all of us to have this opportunity to speak and to communicate and to unfold and to grow, because we got to hear our brother on days. You know, if we didn't come to an understanding within our temple 34 to be a teaching temple before I got there, that was Brother Tundinabay, Brother Ferguson Hill, Brother Cyrus Hill, Sister German Bay, to allow the Moors to be able to get up front without being divine ministers and sheiks and have an opportunity to express their thoughts. You know what I'm saying? To have that opportunity to share their portion of understanding. We might not have had that opportunity to bond as well with our brother. So I just extend those gratitudes, you know, to our Sister E. German Bay as the mother of the temple, as a mother, starting it out in that aspect of love. And you know, just with that, I just extend encouragement to Brother Creddille-Bey. I mean, he sailed on smoother seas. You know, he passed the week of Garvey's birthday. That brother was a soldier, you know what I'm saying? So he transitioned at a certain time. That's still a high vibration. And with that, Moors, I say peace.
Peace. Praise Allah. Thank God. Make a soldier stronger. Do you think God? Make a soldier, do you think I make a soldier? We are the soldiers of Dua. Yes, I think I make a soldier. Yes, I think I make a soldier. Yes, I think I make a soldier, we are the soldier of Dua. Rise and shine and give Allah the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give Allah the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give Allah the glory. We are the soldier of Dua. We are climbing 12-step ladder. We are climbing 12-step ladder. We are climbing 12-step ladder. We are the soldiers of Dua. Rise and shine and give Allah the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give Allah the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give Allah the glory. We are the soldiers of Dua.
Every
round goes higher and higher,
higher.
Every round goes higher and higher,
higher.
Every round goes higher and higher. We are the soldiers of Dua. Islam?
Islam.
I like that one. She is divine minister. She is ill. We're reading from the divine instruction of the Holy Prophet, chapter 19. Disappeared, fully materialized to Eastern sages in the palace of the Prince of Babylon in India, the Magian Prince in Persia, three wise men of the personality of the Nasiri, and she told us to talk about the
transmute.
Friend also, she also touched chapter 10. Praise Allah. Right? Thank you for reading. and also what she shared concerning the brother was surely a soldier of Ju Ali.
Praise Allah.
And we stand the defense of the gospel.
And we
stand for the defense of those things, like I'm saying, because even in the law,
mm-hmm.
you know, you always, we all supported. We always went down there. We always supported him when he had to deal with any kind of case or anything like that. That's what we're here for. Because sisters are brothers. Brother in adversity, sister in trouble, forsake us not. So shall the fortune that thy father continue to support his own race, and still be continued all in love to each other.
So
praise Allah. That more. Every time I think about that more, I would, you know, the smile.
Because
energy is always high, you know, it's always, you know, and very respectable.
Islam.
But I watch him all the time when he's doing his music. He's in another world. He take it up.
0-100.
You know, praise Allah for that more. That more is genuine. Praise Allah. I like that. At this time, I'd like to call the next speaker. Even before I bring it forth, please give me your divine attention. I'd like to thank our little assistant Grand Sheik of W4, Brother W. Creddille-Bey, after the song.
We're on the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We're on the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. He brought us our religion, our flag, and grace. The prophet came to put us on the main line. He connected us back to the human race. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. He came with love and holy zeal. The prophet came to put us on the main line, and he opened up the book of the seven seals. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We're on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We're on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. He came and broke the Roman seal. The prophet came to put us on the main line, and he gave us back our free names, band. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. Allah, Allah, the great supreme. The prophet came to put us on the main line. Praise Allah, we have been redeemed. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line. We on the main line, the main line. The prophet came to put us on the main line.
Islam.
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 I rise and I give praise to the great God of the universe, the author and the creator, and the governor of the world, almighty, eternal, and incomprehensible. I give honor to our illustrious prophet, Noble Ju Ali, who brought us out of the darkness and into the marvelous light.
Praise Allah.
I honor Messiah Garvey and his birthday that just passed. I give honor to the harbinger of the prophet, one of St. Anne's Bay, Jamaica. I give honor to all the prophets of Allah, all the sages, all the masters, all the brothers and sisters of the light. I give honor to all the leaders of the Moorish Science of America, national, state, and local. I give honor to our Grand Sheik and moderator, Brother R. Jones Bay. I give honor to our Grand Sheik at Temple Number 34, Brother Y. Cyrus Hill, and to our chairman, Brother C. Ferguson Hill. I'm just thinking about, like, I'm looking at the Zoom and how our brothers, even in the middle of this pandemic, of serving the prophet in Allah. You know, when the prophet says that you got to crawl to the temple, when the prophet says that you got to be able to go through these days and times, and he give us the different examples, these are some of the things we're talking about. You know, so the brother, Grand Sheik, and the chairman are there serving Allah and the prophet. And I want to give a special honor to you and an honor to all the Moors, all our members, all our guests, and all our family, and everything that the chairman gave honor to. Islam? So I want to give a special honor to our brother that just passed. And I was just thinking about it because the Grand Sheik was posting some of the pictures and I'm listening to some of the Moors. And I just want to read again what the chairman opened up with chapter 10, the sister just mentioned. And I want to talk about how Brother Creddille-Bey was an example of exactly what the prophet is trying to do to our people by becoming more inspired to America in this sense. So chapter 10, Jesus spake on the unity of Allah and man to the Hindus. I'm going to go to instruction 4. The universal Allah is one. Yet he is more than one. All things are one. By the sweet breath of Allah, all life is bound in one. And so if you touch a fiber of a living thing, you send a thrill from the center to the outer bounds of life. And when you crush beneath your foot the meanest worm, you shake the throne of Allah and cause the sword of life to tremble in its sheath. The bird sings out its song for men, and men vibrate in unison to help it sing. The ant constructs its home, the bee its sheltering comb, the spider weaves her web, and flowers breathe to them a spirit in their sweet perfume that gives them strength to toil. Now men and birds and beasts and creeping things are deities made flesh, and how dare you kill anything? It is cruelty that makes the world awry. And when men have learned that when they harm a living thing, they harm themselves, they surely will not kill, nor cause the thing that Allah has made to suffer pain. So what I was mentioning is the Grand Sheik put up a couple pictures that kind of affected me personally. And he put up a picture when the brother first joined the temple. The picture of me giving the brother, he joined with the other brother, his nationality card. And the Moorish Science of America represents family. And Allah is the head of the family. And we're all children of Allah. But our eyes are closed to that fact. But when then you come into the temple, it's like Allah takes you out of the darkness and it opens up your eyes so they're wide open so that you can see the marvelous light. And so I thought about the journey that the brother represents, like every brother and sister. They come into the temple, we don't even know their name. We don't know he's G Belly, the big DJ. You know what I'm saying? Even with my wife, I used to show her my wife on Facebook, you know, because a lot of the songs that he's played is from the era that I grew up. If you listen to his music, you know, he has a genre from a certain age group. Reminds me of growing up and the various things that he was playing of my high school years, my early college years. Here's a brother that I never knew before. I meet him in the temple. And he goes from a brother or sister that we don't know to become Brother Creddille-Bey. And as a couple of years go by, the Grand Sheik has a picture of me and the brother on the prophet's birthday wearing the matching green bow ties, so happy together. And it just remind me of this one instruction right here.
Praise Allah.
By the sweet breath of Allah,
that's right,
all life is bound in one. So if you touch a fiber of a living thing, that's what we're talking about. That brother touched us. And we touched him. And in the touching of each other, send a thrill from the center to the outer bounds of life.
Islam.
It can be dwell on when someone touches you, and the brother has touched us,
right,
and he's our brother. And all the brothers and sisters that come through the temple, we touch each other. We touch a special part of Allah that dwells within each other. And we make that contact, and we show the possibilities of man. And from a stranger became a friend, and from a friend became a brother, and from a brother became a beloved. You know, so it just shows a cycle of the moral temple of America. Just imagine if we take this one example of this one brother, Brooklyn, and spread it throughout New York City, and spread this message of this universal Allah, this universal love. No matter what name you have for Allah, no matter what concept and understanding you have about the prophets or the angels, that if you come into the knowledge of the truth, and you open up your eyes and you come into the marvelous light, you will see things that you never saw before. You will experience the closeness of touching a fiber of a living thing and sending the thrill to the outer bounds. Islam.
Praise Allah.
There's a little wheel of turning. There's a little wheel of turning in my heart. Though there's a little wheel of turning, little wheel of turning, little wheel of turning in my heart. Must be the love of Allah. Must be the love of Allah. Must be the love of Allah in my heart. It must be the love of Allah. Must be the love of Allah. Must be the love of Allah in my heart. Oh, don't you doubt it. Oh, don't you doubt it. Oh, don't you doubt it in your heart.
In your heart.
Oh, Muslim. Oh, don't you doubt it. Oh, don't you doubt it. Oh, don't you doubt it in your heart. It's that old time religion.
Old
time religion
is that
old time religion
in my heart, in your heart. Oh,
it's that old time religion. Old time religion
is that
old time religion in your heart. It must be the sound of the prophet. Must be the sound of the prophet. Must be the sound of the prophet in my heart. Oh, yes, it must be the sound of the prophet. Must be the sound of the prophet. Must be the sound of the prophet in my heart.
Praise Allah.
Islam?
Islam.
I'd like to thank our sister and grand sheikh, Brother W. Creddille-Bey, for reading the divine instruction of the Holy Prophet, chapter 10. Jesus spake of the union of Allah, man, to the Hindus, and spoke about his reflection. That, you know, he gave his brother, I think he gave his brother nationality card.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did. Praise Allah.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's a connection when you start, when you look.
December
2014. Praise Allah. Praise Allah for that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so he's a part of every part of us. You know, we all broke bread together. We all, you know what I'm saying, ride home together. We did a lot of things together.
Islam.
Going trips together. And like I said, it was a blessing. They have that brother in our midst, and like I said, he's still around. Like I said, nothing because the energy, there's no death to the spirit.
The
body go back to the way it come, but you know, there's no death. Man can never die.
Pardon
me. Spirit man is one with Allah. As long as Allah lives, man cannot die. So praise Allah.
Praise Allah.
Allah and man are one.
Islam.
No. I just kind of like to call the last speaker even before I bring it forward. Please give me a divine attention. I'd like to call the Grand Sheikh of Thimble 34, Brother Y. Cyrus Hill, after us all.
The prophet's calling.
You can't hide.
The prophet's calling.
You can't hide.
Oh, the prophet's calling. You can't hide. You can't hide. Miles, you can't hide. The truth done come.
You can't hide.
The truth done come.
Oh,
you can't come, you can't hide. You cannot, Mazel, you cannot. It's judgment day.
You cannot.
It's judgment day.
You cannot.
Oh, it's judgment day. You cannot. You cannot, Mazel, you cannot. Turn your lights down low.
You cannot.
Turn your lights down low.
You cannot.
Turn your lights down low. Oh, you cannot. You cannot, Mazel, you cannot. You can run to the rocks.
You cannot.
You can run to the rocks.
You cannot.
But when the rocks cry out, you cannot. You cannot, Mazel, you cannot. The prophet's calling.
You cannot.
The prophet's calling.
You cannot.
Oh, the prophet's calling. You cannot. You cannot, Mazel, you cannot. Islam, Moses.
Islam.
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 First I rise, and I give praise to Allah, the Father of the universe. Allah is the Father of the universe. Father of love, too. Peace, freedom, and justice. The Quran says, who stretched forth the law, who stretched forth the heavens with his hands, and described with his fingers, the finger, the courses of the stars, who set its bounds to the ocean that it cannot pass, who sail to the stormy winds, he said, shaketh the earth and the nations tremble. Dareth with his lightnings, wicked all dismayed. Calleth forth worlds by the words of his mouth. Smiteth with his arm. They sink to nothing. The Lord continues and says, with respect to his prescience, Allah's prescience, is nothing contingent. With respect to his providence, it's nothing accidental.
That's right.
Continuing. Chapter 35 says, the high and the low, the rich and the poor, the wise and the ignorant, when the soul hath shaken off the cumbrous shackles of this mortal life, shall equally receive from the sentence of just and everlasting retribution according to their works. Then shall the wicked tremble and be afraid, but the heart of the righteous shall rejoice in his judgments. Praise Allah. I give high honors to the last prophet in these days, Prophet Noble Jawali, the founder of the Moorish Science Temple of America, who in the Moorish literature article entitled Divine Warning by the Prophet for the Nations. The Prophet Noble Jawali says, teaches us, when he says, the citizens of all free national governments, according to their national constitution, are all of one family bearing one free national name. Those who fail to recognize the free national name of their constitutional government are classed as undesirables and are subject to all inferior names and abuses and mistreatments that the citizens care to bestow upon them. And it is a sin for any group of people to violate the national constitutional laws of a free national government and cling to the names and principles that delude to slavery. I, the prophet, was prepared by the great God Allah to warn my people to repent from their sinful ways and to go back to the state of mind of their forefathers' divine and national principles. Praise Allah. Prophet Noble Jawali taught us that. Prophet Noble Jawali taught us that we are the Moabites. We were known as the Moabites. Said that we were stripped of our nationality. And we were given the tag names of Negro, Black, and Colored. He told us those were not our names. Question 31 of our questionnaire says, what is the modern name for the Moabites? The answer is Moroccans. And in this fashion, the Prophet Noble Jawali, this is a very powerful Moors. That's so simple, but very powerful, profound. When he gave us back our identity.
You want to trace yourself to the great God Allah and connect to the entire universe, connect ourselves to the brotherhood of life, like the Sister Silzil, I think, in Brother Serrano Bay read from the brotherhood of life. We got to first know who you are. Prophet gave us our identity. Prophet told us that we were citizens of this United States of America. Give high honors to our illustrious prophet, Prophet Noble Dwali. I continue honors to all of the divine prophets. We honor all of the divine prophets. Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, and Confucius, etc. I continue honors to the forerunner to the prophet, Brother Marcus Mosiah Garvey, whose birthday was this week on Thursday. I say praise Allah. It's a powerful time. As Brother Creddille-Bey said, you know, it was almost like he was a personal escort for our beloved brother. Creddille-Bey. I continue honors to all the leaders of the Moore Scientific of America, past and present, giving honors to the first Supreme Grand Advisors and moderators, and the present Grand Sheikh and moderator, Brother R. Jones Bey. I give honors to all national, state, and local officials. I give honors to our Grand Governor here in the state of New York, Brother C. Hurt Bey, and to his assistant, Brother K. Richardson M. I give honors to all of the leaders and the officers, the sheikhs, the ministers at Temple Number 34. Give honors to all of the members. I wanted to give a special honors to my brother, Brother G. Creddille-Bey. The G, for those that don't know, stood for Gary. You know, I call him G. When we weren't in the temple, I called him G. You know, when you're in the temple, I called him Brother G. Creddille-Bey or Brother Creddille-Bey. When they called me on the phone, I called him G. And on his Facebook, I found out, giving honors to his sisters, giving honors to Sister Jody and Sherry. Sherry told me this morning that his mother called him, she called him G-Belly. A lot of his family members knew him as G-Belly. I learned that on Facebook. I never knew what it meant, so I still kept calling him G. You know, who transitioned on Wednesday the 18th, August 18th, at roughly about 10 a.m. Praise Allah. Got a call from his sister, Jody, who I just met. Brother Creddille-Bey would manage to introduce me to his sister in the quick few days when he was decided he was going to make his transition. I give honors to the sisters. Brother Creddille-Bey was my bro. That was my buddy. We were actually very good friends. You know, we are members of the Moore Scientific of America. This brotherhood takes on a lot of different forms. You know, we all become close, but in different ways. And like Brother Ferguson Hill said, Brother Creddille-Bey and I had a common interest in the law. And I would show up whenever he went into the court, and he would support me. At one point, I went in to battle for something. I felt like I needed to stand up for myself. My brother was there, so we had that particular bond. Brother Firksdale would go with us certain times. Sister Silzil was there a few times. I remember Brother King Bay must have come to, I'm trying to remember who else. You know, there's a group of Moors, and sometimes if it's a legitimate cause, you know, the courts. Brother Santana Bay, thank you. If it's a legitimate cause, the courts are constitutional. So when you go in, that's a type of battle. We go in, you call certain people to be there. That was one of our commonalities. You know, Brother Creddille-Bey was, like Brother Serrano Bey said, I, as close as we were, I mean, he would not let me leave the temple without driving me most times if he came, driving me home. If I didn't drive, if I wasn't in the car, he would almost insist. You know, he would meet me at my house certain times just to go take care of certain errands. And we sat in front of the house for hours talking on many occasions. We were close. But he always to me was still very mysterious. And he was a very complex individual in the sense that I've traveled around the globe, a lot of different foreign countries. I've worked with people on all different levels, you know, regular people in the street, destitute people in the street, leaders in the street, and moguls and leaders of the corporate world, many. I mean, you know, you can peruse my Facebook page. I don't even post. You can see that I've been around. But Brother Creddille-Bey was a very different and unique individual, and I would say extremely sophisticated. Like Brother Serrano Bey said, I don't think I ever fully understood him. His humility in the sense that, it was a few years, I've discovered in a debate that he was a lot deeper in terms of his knowledge of the world was way deeper than I had anticipated after I knew him for several years. It was something that one of the more said, Red Pill said something after the debate that allowed me to realize, I don't even really know how deep this brother is. And a leader of men that he was very high. He just came in and sat like a student, but he was intelligent. He knew what he knew. And he definitely did not come in here with it empty handed. The brother was very, very wise, but you wouldn't know it. And then we found out just a few years ago that the brother is a national treasure. In the sense that, and I'm not gonna go into this now, I'm gonna save, it's too much, I'm gonna save this, but his DJing and understanding of the history of hip hop, I have my own label, and I'm a fan of hip hop, and I know it very well. That's all I listen to. This brother was a national treasure based on what he knew. He knew something that was a great misconception about the origins of hip hop, based on being front and center of it. And we didn't know that until just recently. So praise Allah, I'm going to save that. I also enjoyed his music. When we sat and talked one time, he told me about how the type of parties that he would like to go to, that he usually went to. And something told me, wait a minute, this brother's music palette is way different. Then I realized, he's a DJ and a great one. I give high honors to my brother Creddille-Bey. I continue honors to all of the prophets' literature, the divine constitution and bylaws, additional laws, Moorish Holy Quran, the questionnaire, the oral statements, Moorish literature, and everything that the prophet Noble Drew Ali brought for the uplifting of fallen humanity. The prophet Noble Drew Ali said that the Moorish Americans, this comes out of Act 6 of the Divine Constitution and Bylaw, says the Moorish Americans are the descendants of the ancient Moabites, whom inhabited the northwestern and the southwestern shores of Africa. And that statement, you may not understand right away, or maybe it smacks you right away, that is a paradigm-shifting statement. The way that the prophet identified us. We didn't even know who we were. We couldn't tell who we were. They didn't want us to know who we were 500 years ago. Prophet pointed us back to the Garden of Eden and said, you are the Moabites, the descendants of the Moabites, right, who inhabited the northwestern and southwestern shores of Africa, and who were known as the Moroccans. That's paradigm shifting from not knowing who you are to realizing that we are the first tribe of man. It came out of the land of Canaan, the Garden of Eden. I'm just now starting to hear the word Canaan being used. All of a sudden, everybody wants to identify Canaan land. I'm watching this documentary on Jerusalem on CNN, and they talk about Canaan there. I hear Canaan a little bit everywhere. I didn't hear Canaan land used. That term wasn't used for years while I was in the movement. The prophet gave us a powerful paradigm-shifting truth. And he knew it when he made the statement. The prophet is quoted as saying, I got the world in a bottle and a stopper in my hand. He said, I got the gold and the silver. I got the European and the Asiatic. The prophet gave us our identity, and it's profound. When I came into I looked at a lot of different movements before I joined the Moore Science Temple of America. And I considered everything. I found myself in the Library of Industry on 34th Street in like the mid-90s, early 90s. And I was doing a calculation on whether or not we should just fight this out. Doing the numbers of the United States, I'm very diligent. And I said, you know what? That probably would make a lot of sense. And a lot of people could get hurt. But that was my human knowledge. I looked at all the different movements. I joined the Moorish Science Temple of America because what the Prophet Noble Drew Ali did, and this is coming from somebody who, to this day, still, I'm a fighter. I'm getting probably too old to be defending myself when push comes to shove. And thankfully, Allah blessed me with the application of the virtues that I haven't had to. Like, I haven't had a physical altercation in years and years. Maybe 2012 was the last time I tried to fight two people. I came into what the Prophet Noble Drew Ali did for us. There is no, it is the ultimate redemption for what we suffered here in the United States. To stand with the legacy of a Moorish American and say, I declared, I got my card. My card is old. Sister German Bay said her card was from 1963, Moors. During Charter Day. Did y'all hear that? This brother always had the whole oldest card I've ever heard. Other than you get into the real old Moors, you're going to Chicago like that. 1977, Sister German Bay said 1963. That was 10 years before I was born. To live the legacy of a Moorish American is like that cuts to the core. That's the ultimate move, the ultimate redemption for everything we went through. Because it's so symbolic. What we're doing, what the Prophet Noble Drew Ali represents, with this Moorish scientific America, even the fact that it so starts off so humble for so long is so symbolic. If you understand symbols. They were trying to say that there was a group of people saying they're the master race and they set up the Olympics to try to prove us wrong. And today we coated so many cups and rings, it's crazy. We slow walked through the valley of the shadow of death. And there's no prophet there by saying he pinpointed us and took us back to the garden. It's so symbolic. I'm an artist, so I understand symbols. I deal in symbols. This is the ultimate move. It's so brilliant how the prophet brought this in such a high tone, high vibrational tone. He said, go to those who know law, go to your city hall and ask in an intelligent tone. And they'll give you a favorable reply. The vibration is so high. He said, we need to learn to love instead of hate. There's no need for no anger the way the prophet set it up. You know, and this is very potent truth. So that type of potent truth that is like that electrical shocking truth that you try to fight it, you're going to peel layers off. If you represent falsehood, layers is getting peeled off because you can't hide it. All is too much fact. It's the truth. And this prophet exposed it. This is the ultimate redemption. There's no better legacy that you can live to the point that the intelligent, right, is strong enough. What the prophet gave us, it's strong enough to secure the allegiance of the roughest. The roughest of us. I look at Brother Creddille-Bey, and again, I'm examining him, and I'm like, this brother is raw, smart. Like I said, I got a brother. The brothers that I've seen that I have around my friends, this is a powerful individual. Some people say like a Don, you know, they are always extremely smart. Some of the most powerful people that I've known, I think about my cousin Top, who was at King of Temple 21 a couple of years back. Or I think about my brother Mateo, who I used to bring to used to be in the studio. They are not only rough, they are intelligent. Brother Creddille-Bey was that. He was very sharp. And he had an allegiance to the Prophet Noble Drew Ali. Why? Because he knew the power of what the prophet brought. Brother, I'm gonna tell a quick story, Brother Creddille-Bey. It's funny from watching him. I used to sit in the car with him and we'd be talking, and I could tell this brother had a horrible temper. I suffer from one of my vices that I've been trying to figure out how to correct is my temperaments. You know, I talk about it a lot, but this brother had a temperance issue. His was pretty bad. I can see sometimes I'm talking with him and he like, whoa. I'm like, I see this brother is charged up. Never at me, never aimed at me. I've never seen him aim his temper at any of his brothers. But when he would talk about a certain idea, I could just see like his volume would just turn, not his voice, but his energy level. That brother had a bad temper. And it came on display a couple of years back when we had the infamous debate in Harlem. When you look at the photographs that I sent, you see that Brother Creddille-Bey was there. When we went into the it was a weigh-in that they did a month before the debate. There was a debate between Brother Reggie and Brother Polite. And that was the famous story I told you, the Moors. We ended up going in, Sharif had to do a weigh-in. We went into this room with Brother Reggie, who Sharif is debating against. had all of his constituents there. It was about, it seemed like about 5,000 people was in this room. I think it was the Audubon Ballroom. I believe it was the Audubon Ballroom, and which is deep in itself. And we went in there, suited and booted with seven of us. His brother tried to turn the crowd on us. Ultimately, the crowd, at first we didn't know what we were dealing with, but they showed us a lot of love. Brother Creddille-Bey was dead. He was one of the seven. And he drove us there, he wouldn't leave until Brother Sharif was gone. That picture of those last five, Brother Turner-Bey was dead. Brother Martin Stansaway was there. Those last five was the five of seven that were there. We weren't gonna leave the brother in there until we got out. Brother Creddille-Bey was there. He drove us over and he drove us back. In the actual debate itself on April 10th, Creddille-Bey and I remember I was sitting next to Brother Coleman L. Sister Drainale was on the road with us. As this debate was going on, I can't tell you about the debate, you can read about it in the newspaper. Brother Creddille-Bey was getting agitated from the like midpoint, because it was a lot of crazy stuff that kept going on. Brother Hopkins Bays were there in the front row, Sister S. Hopkins Drayton Bays, 70 some odd years old. And the brother Reggie is like telling us, peace, black man. And looking at the Moors like, peace, black man, trying to force us to say, knowing that the Moors ain't gonna say peace, black man, to you. And the brother was getting agitated. And I'm trying to think who else might remember this. At a certain point, he was getting real agitated in his seat. I just gave up. I was like, look, I ain't gonna sit here. I'm the type of person that I cannot calm down a grown man. And I was just like, I don't know what to do. Cause you know, I can tell I can't say nothing to make him calm down. Sister Drainale started coming and working her magic on him. She sat next to him and she like got her arm around him and she's trying to rub the brother on his shoulders and he's calming down. He's calming down. I thought he was calm. I was there. I was the assistant grand sheik at the time. Brother W. Clendenin-Bey, we just heard, was the grand sheik at Temple 34. So I'm like the top officer on the scene, and I'm like, look, this is not getting me. I got to keep the situation under control. I go to the doorway to speak to Brother Stuart Bey, the Mufti from Temple 11, who was on his way to leave. This is at the very end of the debate. The debate was over. And no sooner than I greeted the brother, what happened is Blue Pill, at the end of the debate, Sharif manhandled Reggie. And Red Pill gets up and says, now, Sarnetta, you know, now that everything is clear, that the Moors, we are the heroes. We're here. The Prophet is a hero. We're here to help. Can we now get down to the business of unity? Sarnetta said, "Will," he cut him off, and ultimately, it's almost quickly said, "We'll never have unity. We'll never have unity." And I guess he was trying to say, y'all still different. We see you as y'all ain't the same as us. Brother Creddille-Bey jumped out of his seat. That was it. That Moor jumped out of his seat, knocked the chair over. He was on the aisle. He was on the aisle against the wall. And he beat the Moors before anybody could catch him. Out of his seat, down the aisle. He was turning the corner, going up on the stage before the Moors in the front end. There was some Muftis. Brother Jordan there was in a Mufti format with some of the Moors. They were in camo. They swarmed around Sarnetta to protect him from the Creddille-Bey. He was going to get him. I remember being very upset about it the days afterwards. But, you know, in hindsight, I realized that I forgave Brother Creddille-Bey for it. But the brother was right in a sense that, well, I understood that he just had no tolerance for falsehood. And he was that passionate that he just couldn't, his tolerance got loose from him. You know, he saw it as folk, and what was said was really, a lot of people were really offended by it. You know, I was very proud to share the history that I have with my brother Creddille-Bey. I'm very, very proud of it. I don't know if sometimes I guess just the type of person, I don't make this mistake that you meet and make a relationship and you're like, I don't know if I should have been in a relationship with that person. I'm proud to be the brother, and for that to be my brother. Brother G. Creddille-Bey, you know, I wanted the Moors to know that he's definitely not gone. Like Sister Sealsdale taught us, I'm gonna take out my reading before I sit down. The Creddille-Bey ain't gone. You know, that's not the science. You know, this is the science of the Prophet Noble Juali, the Moor Science Temple of America. I'm gonna take a reading from chapter number 18, and I'm gonna read instructions 15 to 24. This is the chapter before. This is in that midst of that same story Sister Silzio read from, right? Maybe the day before. This is on page, it starts on page 28. Instruction number 15, this is the resurrection of Jesus, right? Pilate places the Roman seal upon the stone door of the tomb. At midnight, a company of the silent brotherhood march about the tomb, etc. Instruction number 15 reads, now Jesus did not sleep within the tomb. The body is manifest of soul, but the soul is without its manifest. And in the realm of souls unmanifest, the Lord went and taught. He opened up the prison door and set the prisoner free. He broke the chain of captive souls, led the captives to the light. He sat in council with the patriarchs and prophets of olden times, the masters of all times and climes he met. And in the great assemblies, he stood forth and told the story of his life on earth and of his death and sacrifice for man, and of his promises to clothe himself again in garb of flesh and walk with his disciples, just to prove the possibilities of man, to give to them the key of life, of death, and of the resurrection of the dead. In council, all the masters sat and talked about the revelations of the coming age, when she, the holy breath, shall fill the earth and air with holy breath and open up the way of man to perfectness and endless life. Praise Allah. That more is, I'd like to thank everyone. I'm going to stop right there. I'd like to thank everyone for the words that they shared this evening. And I'm going to extend everyone a happy holy day. And I'm going to ask the prophet, I'm going to take some words, the thought from my brother, W. Creddille-Bey. I'm going to ask the prophet, Noble Drew Ali, ask our prophet to find our brother, take his hand and help, get him to the next phase, move him, carry him to where he needs to go. That's the science. I pray that the prophet find Brother Creddille-Bey, or if he didn't already, get him by the hand and lead him to the way that he needs to go. With that, I leave him all. Peace.
Can you feel in your soul the changes coming on from every walks of life? People are seeking the light. Can you feel it in your heart now? A new world is taking shape. With Prophet Drew Ali, we learn to love instead of hate. Reach out and touch a hand. Make a friend if you can. Reach out and touch a hand. Make a friend if you can. Well, what about you, my friend? Why don't you come on in? Join in the most today and make this world a better place. Reach out and touch your hand. Make a friend if you can. Reach out and touch your hand. And make a friend if you can. We'll praise our Lord. He sent us Drew Ali, a prophet of humanity. He brought the truth to make us free. Reach out and touch your hand. Make a friend if you can. Reach out and touch your hand. And make a friend if you can.
Islam?
Islam. Like Ted Graham, she gets me with emotional energy at the beginning. Also, you read from the divine instruction from the Holy Prophet, chapter 18, the resurrection of Jesus, Pilate placed the Roman seal upon the stone door of the tomb. At midnight, the company of the silent brethren marched about the tomb. Soldiers are along. Jesus speaks to the spirit in prison. Early Sunday morning, he rises from the tomb. The soldiers are bribed by the priest to say, the disciple is thrown in the body. Verse 16 to verse 24. I thank you for his reading and also for his comments.
Praise Allah.
At this time, I read the one. Islam.
Islam.
Divine warning by the Prophet W.R. Prophet warns all Muslims, governors, for the reproclamation at each meeting. I hereby inform all members that they must end all radical agitated speeches while at work, in their homes, or on the street. We are for peace and not destruction. Stop flashing your cards if your opinions are causing confusion. Remember, your card is for your salvation. Failure to obey these orders will be a severe consequence. We are for love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice, and when these principles are violated, justice must then take its course. Any member or group of members who hold malicious feelings toward the temple or the prophet will violate the divine covenant of the Moorish movement, will receive their reward from the law for their unjust deed. All true Moors will and must obey the law as laid unto them by their prophet. If they lose confidence in their prophet, they should turn in their card and button, cease wearing their turbans and fez, and return to the state of I, the prophet found you. This is a holy and divine movement founded by the prophet of Jerusalem. And the prophet is not right, the temple is not right. The prophet therefore sending out the divine plea to all Moorish Americans that they do their part in protecting their prophet and the temple. It's an everlasting movement founded by the prophet to the will of Allah to redeem his people from their simple way by order of prophet Noble Drew Ali. Peace. Praise Allah.
Praise Allah.
Which
is up on the screen.
All right, we go. We're going to do some announcements. Brother T-Berry Bay.
If he's dead, let's see if he gives a word.
Islam, Grand Gov. Islam, happy holy day.
Holy day.
Islam.
First, I want to rise and give praise to Allah, and I give honors to his holy and divine prophet. And I give honors to everything the chairman, the grand sheikh, and all the Moors gave honors to. Praise Allah. I apologize, grand sheikh. I didn't see the text. I was in the meeting, but I didn't realize that you can't always see who's in the meeting. Mm-hmm. So I apologize for that. And I seen your text around time AGS was speaking, and I seen the text, and I said, oh, man, I dropped the ball. And I know my brother Creddille-Bey was like, come on, Moore, you're not going to say a word, Moore. I could just hear him in my head just getting at me. So I said, oh, man, I gotta say something during secretary time. Yeah, that was a beautiful demonstration the Moors gave regarding our brother. You know, he was a musical, historical archive when it came to that music. You know, he touched all bases, and he represent Brooklyn. You know, Brooklyn, the Brooklyn DJ scene. He wanted to, he's going to, because we're going to keep his legacy alive.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he wanted to get it out to the world that, you know, DJ didn't start up in the Bronx, not that type of DJing, as they say. You know, and he proved it to me with empirical evidence. So that's why I said, brother, I have to get behind you. You know, I have to get behind you, you know, but, you know, we're going to miss our brother Creddille-Bey, you know, DJ Jelly Belly, you know, but I just was listening to him earlier, you know, listen up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you know, he's getting ready to cut up.
Yeah.
He's getting ready to cut up when he say, listen up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you know, but, you know, we'll always have those videos and we'll always have those, you know, those interviews he did to always look back on to carry his legacy. And I'm gonna say one more thing and put a period on it. That picture the AGS was talking about when he first gave him his nationality card. If you look really well, if you look hard at that picture, you could tell that he was humbly excited. And, you know, you could tell he was trying to keep, you know, he had his pride, but you could tell inside he was doing the running man. You know, he was real excited when he got that nationality card. But yeah, I just want to apologize for that, Grand Sheik. I did not, I missed the text on that. But and thanks for calling on me. Yeah, I appreciate the Moors. Happy Holy Day. And with that, I say peace.
Peace, Brother Bad Bay. Travel safe, you and the Seekers. Praise Allah. Tell them more as we said Islam, actually, when you get to the destination.
Anybody online that wants
to peace?
Anybody online, sister homie, that want to say something about the brother? I know you touched a lot of Moors. So I don't know who's online.
Islam, Grand Gov, anyone that would like to say a few words, please go ahead and raise your hand so that we can call on you. Praise Allah. We have a hand by Brother Creddille-Bey and Jay Colmanil.
Oh, Brother Creddille-Bey.
Islam. First, I want to rise and give praise to the great God Allah, Father of the universe, the Father of love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. I want to give high honors to our Prophet, Prophet Noble Jew Ali, high honors to everything the chairman gave honors to, honors to all the Moors on the call. And Islam, Moors, my brother Creddille-Bey, the brother had a very powerful, powerful aura, as you stated, Grand Sheik. And, you know, even at that debate, it was real serious, more because, you know, in a way, you know, at that time I was still, I was still at Temple 21, still a member of Temple 21. And, you know, it was a lot of things in the air, you know what I mean? To not demonstrate, not make that demonstration. But, you know, you could tell where the ethers were pulling the Moors at that time. So it was something almost greater than, you know, anybody who really had eyes could have had to see that we had to demonstrate that day. But, you know, there was a lot of falsehood, a lot of things, you know, talk about feeling the ethers. Like from being in the temple, you become an adept at feeling ethers, you know what I mean? And they were trying to really turn the crowd on the Moors that day. So, you know, when the guy who stood up with the locks, forgot his name, you know, guy with the locks, you know, he has his head shaved off, but he had, right, exactly. He began speaking and you know, I must admit that, you know, I couldn't really deal with the falsehood. So, you know, from where I was sitting with some of the brothers, you know, I began kind of like yelling out, like at the guy with the locks, you know what I mean? I'm barking on him, but I'm not standing up. I'm sitting down and I'm like, because, you know, the falsehood he was spitting, I could tell the energy, my subconscious picked up the energy of the crowd, kind of trying to ride his wave, right? Mm-hmm. So after doing that, you know, after making that, well, I kind of, you know what I mean? Got into my, you know, got into my lower self for a minute, but shortly after that, that's when the brother Creddille-Bey stood up. Like when Sarnetta said what he said, brother Creddille-Bey stood up like, yo, they're not going to get it more. They're not going to get it. We're wasting our time here. And it's like, and it was so ironic because I kind of tried to talk to our brother like, yo, brother, why? You know what I mean? We didn't have to take it that far. And the brother was like, yo, I did it for you, Mo. Yeah. I did it for you. And I'm like, yo, because at the end of the day, he was catching the vibe like of the falsehood that was being brought out.
Right.
And he just shut me down. Like, I couldn't say anything. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, I just want to give honors, man. And I just want to give honors to the brother, you know what I mean? His family and everything that is going on in this day and time. It's like, but like, you know, Sister Seals Ill said, you know, the brother's sailing on smoother seas and, you know, he's at peace, you know what I mean? And we carrying on that vibration here to carry, you know, to make that transition even the more smoother. But you know what I'm saying? You have your people that's still tied down to the earth plane and, you know, we're the rock that the brother could sail. We're the landing pad or the takeoff pad, you know what I mean? So the brother could go back to the highest plane of life, you know what I mean? And transcend. So with that, I say peace.
Praise Allah. Peace. Thank you, Brother Creddille-Bey.
Thank you, Brother Creddille-Bey. Praise Allah. Brother Jay Coleman here. Yes, get this, brother.
I want to make a quick announcement while we wait on Brother Coleman. If you're having trouble unmuting your mic, just unmute when you get a chance. Say Islam. Or if not, we'll go to the next person. I didn't get a chance to say, I don't know if I got a chance to announce more, is that I meant to say this while I was speaking, that the family asked Temple number 34 to organize the funerals and oversee the funeral services for Brother G. Creddille-Bey. Praise Allah. I started to put that in the chat this afternoon. I said, meeting. Sister Jody called me this morning. Now she texted me. And then that's how I got it. When I called her, I spoke to Sister Sherry. Sister Jody told me that they wanted to respect the principles of their brother and have him go out in the way that he would have wanted. Now, of course, this was, I'm sure Brother Creddille-Bey was not expecting to, that he was going to cross over on August 18th of 21. So he probably didn't have everything in place that he would say, this is the instruction. So they had to go based off of their hearts. And they asked Temple 34 to arrange the services. And I say, praise Allah, because that does not always happen. You know, as we are at this early stage of waking up the nation, and I give high honors to the family for that selection, but I wanted to let the Moors know. I'll be sending more information about it as tomorrow we're going to meet to select a date and of all of the details, and I'll share that with the Moors.
Peace. Praise Allah. Peace. Praise Allah.
Islam, anybody else? Islam, Brother Coleman, are you back?
Yeah, Brother Peter's ill right there.
If not, we can move on. We have Brother T-Berry Bey and Brother Peter's ill.
Islam.
Islam, Brother Coleman. Islam,
call me from earlier. I'm not working Islam? Anything, but you know, I just wanted to say a couple words, you know, like, I give honors and gratitude to the brother because the brother made his meeting, his last meeting. He made his last meeting on Charter Day. Mm-hmm. On Charter Day, that brother made his last meeting. And, you know, I was talking to the brother the night before. We was actually chopping it up because, you know, I make beats. And he was telling me, he's like, oh, you make so much beats, man. I can't wait to see you at the temple the next day. You know, it was just an honor just to actually meet the brother. You know, the brother was so humbly. You know, just like Brother Serrano B was saying today, he was saying how the brother always say, call me more, I'm gonna miss the brother. I'm gonna miss seeing the brother. I know he's in a better place spiritually, but physically, I'm gonna miss seeing that brother, that more right there. You know, he did a lot of good demonstrations pertaining to music, you know, DJing, things of that nature. You know, it was an honor to know that brother, to shake that brother's hand. It was an honor. To communicate with him.
Yeah,
I love. And at the debate, that brother represented the movement.
Yeah,
but peace and love, Morris.
Peace, peace. Thank you, brother.
Brother Jay Peters here.
Islam, Morris.
Islam.
Islam, first and foremost, I want to rise. Give praise to the great God of the universe. I want to give honors to all his prophets, most especially the one he sent for us to North America, our prophet Noble Jew Ali, and everything he brought for the uplifting and the fall of humanity. I want to give honors to the charter that allows us to practice Islamism in America without any molestation. With that, I say peace.
Peace.
Man, our brother GC, man. Our brother GC, bro. I just wanted to say a quick few words about our brother, you know, from my perspective. A solid brother, man. A solid brother. Like I had the privilege to grow up around some older OGs, for the lack of a better word, right? Some OGs that had some good qualities, good principles, even though they was in the life they was in. And you could just tell where the brother come from and where he was at, you know, his vibration, his everything is just bleed Brooklyn. Just bleed Brooklyn. Just familiar. Just a familiar vibe, you know. And It's like that when he was in, when he was at Charter Day, it was like something just dragged me down to the seat, because I haven't seen my brother in a while, but something really just dragged me in the seat and to chop it up with him. And I did, but who would have known that would have been the last time that I was able to build with my bro. You know? But always for the best, man. Always for the best, man.
What's your name?
Huh?
Hang on 1 second, Brother Peterson.
Hang on 1 second.
We got a guest in
here. It's not.
Maybe about 5 minutes or so. It's not. Praise Allah. We had several guests actually in the temple today. Brother Peterson, I want you to continue, including a sister and her daughter. Daughter maybe looking 5 years old, 7 years of five. Yeah. Your face looks familiar. Put the face together. Oh, Brother Rajib Bey. Praise Allah. Brother Oni Bey is here. Brother Commander Hebel from the Black Panther Party. We also had two additional guests, one that we've seen, one that we didn't see. There's about seven more here. Brother Oni Bey's here. But please, Brother Peterson, please continue more. Thank you for interrupting. Take your time.
All is well. All is well, Ma. I was about to wrap it up anyway, but just wanted to make sure, you know, may Allah be pleased with the brother's works, with the brother's great works in music and all endeavors in life, you know. And peace and love.
Peace and love. We got Brother Miles Bey, Brother Turner Bey, with the hands up. I think Brother T. Barry Bay, if your hand is meant to still be up,
Islam, Grand Sheik. Yes, I just wanted to say, Grand Sheik, the picture that picture that you all took, that classic picture with you all, yourself, Brother Martin Stansewell, Brother Turner Bay, Annie O'Bay, that picture to me, it's time for it to be framed. And I always look at that picture as, you remember the movie Untouchables with Elliot Ness in them? I put together the team to take down Capone.
Right.
That was the team right there. I mean, it was the other Moors too. It was more Moors than that. But right. When you all went up there and represented like that, you know, for the Prophet, you kind of, the conscious community has never been the same. Wow. You know, never been the same. So that picture to me, that looked like the picture of the Untouchables. with Elliot Ness. And I want to say also, I want to give a happy born day to Brother PJ Peterson. Happy birthday, my good brother. And with that, I say peace.
Happy born day, beloved.
Much gratitude, bro.
Allah, happy birthday. Happy birthday, dear brother.
Much gratitude, Mo. Much gratitude.
Right behind the forerunner.
Yeah,
Islam.
And very good thought, Brother Barry Bay. I'm gonna do that actually. That's one of the photographs. That's an awesome idea. Maybe
Islam Grand Sheik.
From here, we'll put him in the temple.
Hey, Islam Grand Sheik, that picture you took with him with the blue shirt, he was actually having a conversation with Brother T. Barry Bay. I remember because you were sitting with me and you said, let me go take this picture of the two brothers communicating. I remember like yesterday.
Right.
Praise Allah.
Exactly right. Yep.
Absolutely.
Praise Allah.
Sister, what's your name, sis?
We want to pause for a minute. Okay. We have a visitor in the temple. We want to give her a chance. I think she may have a question and a statement. We're gonna ask her to come up. Sis, can you give us your name again? Because we may take a little longer than 5 minutes, and I think she may have to leave.
Yeah, we don't want to
hold
you. Hi, little one.
We can't see, Grand Sheik. Can we see?
Yes. I'm gonna turn the camera on so they can see you. Hang on 1 second, Sister Silzo. Let's see.
Praise Allah.
I'm gonna put the camera here.
Hello, princess. Come on up. Let us see. Come on, see. Beautiful sis.
So, sis, give us your name again.
Peace, sister.
My name is Marjorie. Her name is Layla.
Layla?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
We're here. This is not our first time.
Okay.
Brother, if you recall, we were on the online, and now that
right.
Online.
Yeah.
So and why I'm here.
Okay.
The readings that I'm doing on
Bring your love.
We in this one, watch, be careful with the show. No, she can touch the books, but if you lean on that one, it's kind of unbalanced. It might fall and say, that'll trick you. How are you able to, when you look at New York?
Right here in Brooklyn. You can RC East 79th Street.
Okay, bring your love.
Yes. We, do you want to take your number?
Yes.
I'm going to go off the test so it doesn't go over the airwaves. And I'm going to connect you so that you can communicate with us via our Facebook chat. And you'll be able to, if you want to join in via Zoom. We'll be in person next week, Friday, next weekend. We're asking the room to take a COVID test just to make sure that everyone is negative. Hopefully that's not a huge challenge.
No, it's
some people are even afraid of the test, and I don't mind. I was in there looking at the Q-tip too, like, look, what's on here? I need to see you come out of the wrap-up. But we'll be here next week. I'm going to get your information so that you can continue to communicate.
Yes.
Just Marjorie,
yes,
and the daughter's name is
Layla,
like Layla Ali.
Yes,
nice to meet you.
You ready?
Can you write the name? I'll give up with that one.
Yes,
something. Write it on this.
So the next service will be on Sunday
at 2:00.
Yes,
it'll be closed like this. Most of the malls are online because this weekend we were closed, but you're welcome to come in. If that's your favorite, actually. But next week, when everyone is invited, we just want to make sure we're going to kind of tighten up our restrictions in terms of masks and temperature, taking the temperature and everything else. So, if you could come, nice to meet you, Sister Mark.
Yes.
Nice to meet you, Layla.
Nice to meet you.
Peace.
Nice to meet you both. She's so beautiful.
Nice to meet you, Sister. Welcome to the More Scientific America.
Praise Allah. Praise Allah. So we also had a few more hands. We had Brother Peters there was speaking. I'm trying to think who else we had. Brother Creddille-Bey. Brother K. Creddille-Bey had his hand up.
It's long, Morris. Oh man. She was speaking of that day, boy. The tension, you can feel the tension in the air.
Right.
You know?
Well, good.
Both hatred, admiration, wonder. You know, it was like a question in the air, you know, are we all the turmoils? Right.
Brother Reggie was trying to stir up the crowd of that 5,000, three, I don't know if it was three or five, it seemed like 5,000 people were in there. He was trying to stir them up.
Yeah, but the funny thing about that is, you can't be a wise man and be a fool at the same time.
Right.
And the things that he did, the mental space he was coming from was of a college educated professor, right?
Mm-hmm.
So his knowledge of us only went but far as what they wanted to tell you.
Right.
But the brother that's standing to your left, to my right.
Mm-hmm.
See, I knew the brother. You know, we from Brooklyn, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you know, I'm going to just say we come from the same cloth, you know.
You another one, but it's going to be Islam. Exactly.
Yeah, he's definitely someone to know, you know. A very good brother, could talk. I remember one time he drove me home in his van. And we sat and talked for like an hour, just chopping it up, mostly on naught, after we spoke intelligently, then the gate started to open up, and we was closer than we even thought,
Wow.
So, with the people we know and the people we dealt with, it was very eye opening, you know. And brother was a real good brother, very serious in his principles, you know. Very serious, you know. I just had high esteem for the brother, you know. Very, very, very much. I salute, you know, his physical life while he was here with us, you know. And I'm kind of sad that I didn't get to spend, you know, his day, that day when he came to the charter day with him, you know. I think it would have affected me, my emotions a little bit more, but you know, I'm happy, you know. That's all I wanted to say. Peace and love, Moss.
Moss, I want to put a donation together. I want to go through the sheets properly. That's the clear, so that we're all on the same page. And even if there's any additional ideas, but I'm gonna do personally a donation to the family. And I'm gonna try to arrange something for the temple. So if the Moors would like to contribute something to help, I don't know enough about Brother Creddille-Bey, you know, to say whether that he don't need, he's literally that mysterious. I could, you know, there's a picture I wish I could have brought up of him and his sister. And I'm struggling, I don't think I have it anywhere handy that I could just pull it up. Him and his sister, he's about 2 or 3 years old. He got a gift of a little DJ table, a little plastic DJ table, and his sister's standing there with him. Nice. And I mean, there's a lot that you can glean from a photograph. You know, I don't know if the Creddille-Bey family need it or they don't need it. I don't get the feeling like they need it, but I would still like to do a donation. So something that if you would like to contribute,
bye-bye.
Bye, Layla. Bye. Peace and love, sisters. See you on Sunday. Peace and love. If you would like to contribute, you can use our Temple Cash App, $MSTA34, to do that. And we'll gather that together and get it out to the family at some point. So I just wanted to add that in there real quick. Any last thoughts before we close out? We're going to send this video. This is being recorded, and I'm going to make sure that the family gets this. I think this is like when we get together for the funeral, we'll probably be specifically about his life and what he did to the family. It'll maybe a little bit more formal, but not everyone, of course, there's not as many speakers, but this tape is just a recording is to let the family know about his actual family, his other family over here, and our actual thoughts as individuals toward him. So I think it's special. It actually worked out good that we're having this for him tonight. While the daughters, while our brother is still walking around, he's probably sitting in here. Brother Creddille-Bey probably sitting right in here somewhere. I know exactly where he's sitting at. Anytime you ever looked at the photos of Brother Creddille-Bey, I just realized it when I gathered all those pictures together. He only sits in one spot. All these years, there's a couple photographs, the pictures are changing, the people changing around him, but I'm thinking it looked like the same photo. He sat in the same spot when he was here, but we'll be sending this to the family. Peace.
Islam.
Islam.
We have a hand by Brother P. Miles Bey and Sister C. Silzil.
Brother Miles Bey.
Islam, Brother P. Miles Bey.
Islam, beloved.
Islam. First I rise, give praise to Allah, give honor to the Prophet, give honor everything pertaining to Islam. I just wanted to say, you know, it was definitely an honor to meet the brother on charter day of all days. You know, he definitely gave me some good knowledge about DJs and how everything started and things like that. You know, I'm kind of, you know, saddened that I wasn't able to build with the more, much more than we did the day at the charter day, especially since, you know, the Grand Sheik was the one who made the introduction and said that, you know, he wanted me to get to know the more. Mm-hmm. And really saddened about this whole situation.
Islam, don't be.
Peace.
You know, death is no enemy to man.
A friend.
And there are no strange happenings. Law governs all events. And the Holy Quran, I'm going to say this real fast, in the Holy Quran of Mecca, one of the things that always fascinated me in that teaching is that it says somewhere in there, it has a lesson about a fly. It says, man, you, that's the law saying, man, you are so powerless, you couldn't hurt a fly unless I allowed you to. You know, you can't hurt a fly unless I allowed you to. No one can harm you. Nothing happens without the, you know, without the prescience of the great God Allah. You know, and regarding his prescience, there's nothing contingent. Nothing is contingent upon it. So, you know, Allah works through us, and he has a predestined plan, and everything is happening exactly the way that it should be. And, you know, the cause of death are always for the best because we are solving problems there as well as here. And man will find himself where he can solve his problems best.
Praise the Lord.
So my brother Creddille-Bey was ready to move. You know, some part of him and the great God Allah, they was ready to move to the next phase. But we'll definitely see him again. So with that, I say peace.
Peace. Sister CCLZL.
Circle 7. How many days are in a week, right? We talk about 7 days. Talk about how many days are in a year, how many days are in the creation. But Wednesday, I was born on a Wednesday. It's symbolic for the concept that the brother transitioned on a Wednesday. And I know Wednesday is symbolic of, you know, as they may call it, the Norse god, the Odin, right? And even Mercury, because, you know, miracle is, right? And that goes right into what? That goes into the realm associated with wisdom, the magi or magic, as some may call it, victory, and even, you know, death. Mercury, conceptually, he used to guide the souls after, quote unquote, death. And so I just want us to kind of just, even if we look at it and we understand the signs and symbols for the conscious mind, we can just look at it a little differently and just even see the energy, the power on that transition and what we gain. We have family here and we also have family there. And so we just gained a brother on the other side. And with that, I say peace. Thank you so much, Moses.
Praise Allah. Anyone else before we close out? Praise Allah. Praise Allah.
Islam. I just wanted to let the Moses know, you know, our prophecy says there's no happenings. And the brother passed form on one of my uncle's birthdays. So the brother's amongst some good energy, you know? He's definitely amongst some good energy and some good help. Peace.
Praise Allah. We got a birthday now, Marcus Garvey. It's a lot of signs and symbols.
Praise
Allah. Praise
Allah.
Islam?
Islam.
I don't have any other announcements off the top of my head. My mind, I had tunnel vision all week, Moses. I can't. You know, the brother's been in my thoughts, so if I forgot something, I'll go over it on Monday. Sunday, Monday.
Islam.
Islam, sister.
Do you want to end the slideshow?
Yes, I'm going to end the slideshow, and also, Sister Harmony, thank you. I have that the outro. We're going to play that too. Hopefully we have space. I'll play it, and when it ends, I think you'll end the meeting.
Islam.
Praise Allah.
Islam. I'd like to thank everyone for their contribution physically, spiritually, and financially. I pray Allah continue to guide us. I pray Allah continue to protect us. I pray Allah continue to shield us against all negative forces seen and unseen. And don't forget to rally prayer. Also, put your energy in the force to heal the world. Because you can send a trip from the center to the outer bound of life. Every living thing is marked by force and every other living thing. All like minds attract, all like other like minds expel. So we want to be able to attract, right? That's it, Brandon.
Yes, sir.
All right, face the east. Five fingers on the left, two on the right, two on the rear. Repeat motion, heart and prayer. Allah, the Father of the universe.
Allah, the Father of the universe.
The Father of love.
The Father of love.
Truth.
Peace.
Freedom.
Freedom.
And justice.
And justice.
And justice.
Allah is my protector.
Allah is my protector.
My
guide.
My God.
My salvation.
Salvation.
By night.
By night.
And by day.
By day.
Through his holy prophet.
Through his holy prophet.
Through Ali. Amen.
Amen.
We'll be right back.